Yes, good afternoon, all of you. That's where we have stopped. Can somebody tell me? Northeast to me. I think, okay, Manipur. Different conflicts we have seen in Manipur, right from secessionism, okay, that is demand for separate Manipur. Separate Manipur. Who is asking for the separate Manipur? Yes, UN, United Nation, United National Liberation Front, United National Liberation Front, PLA. Yes, People Liberation Army. Okay, so this is a secessionist movement. The basis is they have the Manipuri culture as a very distinct culture. Okay, the history and the culture, on the basis of that, they are saying historically also they have the separate kingdom, and culturally there is a distinct culture. So in order to preserve, they are asking for the separate Manipur. But again, I have mentioned that secessionist demand has been more or less not creating a lot of trouble, but something else, that is the internal problems or internal conflicts between the different tribes. So in internal conflict, the three major tribes here, Maitis tribe and, yes, Kuki and Naga. Okay, now this is a dominant tribe and they enjoy the scheduled tribe status. This lives in a plain area. These are the hilly tribes. Okay, so there is always, and since they enjoy the ST status, they have moved ahead, and therefore there is a continuous conflict, and this continuous conflict is at the heart of the problem of internal. Now this conflict get manifested itself into the different forms. So one of the present times we have seen, that is a conflict with respect to creation of, yes, states, creation of districts, new districts. We have also seen that is contention of government of Manipur is for the administrative purpose, that is new districts are being created, whereas the Naga feel that this is an ploy in order to reduce the Naga into the minority. Okay, so therefore there is a conflict in between. Kuki has nonetheless have accepted, because some other way it has indirectly benefited the Kuki tribe. So there is a demand that this creation of new districts, this has to be taken back, but government has went ahead with it, following which the Naga has went on for the Naga blockade, or what do we call as a Manipur blockade. So Manipur blockade, we have seen that how it has taken the life of out of the tune, because there's all essential commodities, oil, diesel, petrol, or rest of the other items, okay, that is cooking fuel also. So these things are not reaching, essential commodities are not reaching, because the two important highways, that is National Highway number 2nd and 37, has been blocked, and there is a ongoing insurgency. We have also seen Naga is backed by United Naga Council, which itself you can understand backed by yes, NSCNIM. Okay, although it is not officially stated. Okay, so officially it is UNC, and there are allegations that UNC is working on the behest of NSCNIM. Now they have going for this Naga blockade, and therefore the conflict is happening. Apart from that, now if you see, so this was the one of the issue, that is the creation of districts. The next issue you can write, there is a third issue, fourth issue, that is inner line permit. Okay, issue with respect to demand of inner line permit. Basically, see, there are different aspects here required to be understood here. First, you need to know what is ILP. Okay, where all ILP is there, why ILP came into being, and why Manipur is demanding for ILP. Okay, so these are some of the things that you must address. What is inner line permit? Where it exists, whether it exists or not? Why ILP came into being, okay, wherever it exists, and why now the Manipur is demanding for the ILP. Okay, so the first is, what is ILP, inner line permit? Yes, what is inner line permit? Cross the? Yes, few states rather, okay. Yes, so it's sort of a visa that is required when you travel to the other countries. You require a visa, okay, unless and until you have the visa. Visa is what is the permit, okay, that has been granted to you for a variety of the reason, maybe the education, work, or for a tourism visa. But within the country we have a free flow of people, okay, that is what is the Article 19 says. But there is an exception, and this exception is like for three states where it exists. ILP Manipur mein nahi, Manipur demanding now. Yes, Nagaland, Mizoram and Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, so in these three states you require a permit, separate permit, if you are an outsider. So right, what is ILP? ILP is an official document. Official document. Official document. Granting the permission. Official document granting the permission. Permission. To enter into three states, to enter into three states, namely Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland and Mizoram. Official document of permission required to enter into three states. Okay, if the person is outsider, comma into inverted comma, if the person is outsider, here the outsider is not out of the country, outsider of three states, so in bracket you can write outsider, then he must possess ILP to enter in above three states. Otherwise, you cannot. Okay, so, and there are other lot of things. Are there short-term ILP, long-term ILP? Wo itna jaruri nahi hai. But this is an important to understand that some sort of document is required in order to enter into. So, if you are not belonging to these three states, you cannot enter without the permission. That is the ILP. Now, second aspect is where it is. Obviously, we have already covered. Now, Manipur is demanding. First of all, let's see that what is the rationale of ILP, okay? Rationale of ILP, or how ILP came into being. Kyun ILP teen state ke liye banayi gayi? Now, if you see the origin, it is a historic in origin. Historic in a sense that the Britishers have actually come up with the idea of ILP in order to protect their commercial interest, so that any outsider should not enter and purchase the land and the property inside the three countries, and they have already have the contract with respect to the people, local people. So jo plantation and spices the wahan pe, to uska protection karne ke liye they have come up with the ILP. Obviously this was an unstated objective. The stated objective is to preserve their culture, etc. Okay, so right, historically the idea of ILP came into being before independence. Idea of ILP came into being before independence. Britishers in order to protect their commercial interest. Britishers in order to protect their commercial interest. In order to protect their commercial interests, came up with this idea of ILP. Okay, underline the word this, commercial interest, and by the Britishers. Now, in spite of the India got independence, why it existed then post-independence? Okay, so right in continuation, post-independence, government of India continued with ILP. Post-independence, government of India continued with ILP in order to protect, preserve and promote unique culture and tradition of different tribes in respective states. Understood? Okay, so commercial was their objective, but India has continued in order to preserve their, yes, that is a cultural interest. So this is basically to preserve the pristine beauty, natural beauty, cultural aspects from getting exploited by the outsiders. So that was the purpose here. Now, right, the demand of ILP by Manipur. Now, why the Manipur is demanding? See, the very interesting things. यहाँ पे जो है separate Manipur चाहिए इनको, ठीक है? तीनों demand अलग-अलग है. मतलब ये जो Manipur है तो Manipur का अलग country बना दो. दूसरा है कि नहीं बना, internal एक problem है उनके बीच में. और तीसरा problem है कि ठीक है country भी बाहर नहीं निकल रहा है, internal भी नहीं है. एक तो काम कर दो कि इसके ऊपर wall लगा दो, so that nobody can enter and we ourselves. So all the three are distinct from each other. One is they want to get out of it. So they are saying that if you are not giving us a country demand, at least give us that sort of a protection so that the outsiders will not come into the Manipur. So whenever you have to understand the ILP, it is not basically between the different Manipuri tribes, but it is more about Manipuri as a thing. That is the internal Manipur people versus the outsiders. Okay, so they want that. Now, what are the reasons for we will discuss? So, right, the demand of ILP by Manipur. So, Manipur people are demanding ILP in order to protect Manipuri culture and the economic and commercial interest of Manipuri people getting exploited because of immigration from outsiders. यहाँ पे outsiders not necessarily Bangladeshi नहीं है, okay? ये immigration मतलब Bangladeshi ऐसा नहीं है. Anybody from out of the Manipur is entering. So put that outsider into inverted comma. So it is not Bangladeshi, it is not out of country, it is the internal Indians who are coming there. Now this is something what we discuss in case of Maharashtra, what is this son of soil theory, that people are coming from outside and taking the bread and butter of the local people. So this is where we see that a sort of regionalism tendencies. So same thing we see here also. Like somebody is coming from out, they have this feeling that they are actually taking the, see, whenever you say the culture, it is more about the economics rather than the culture, okay? So because they are feeling that outsiders are coming, taking the lands, establishing the shops, commercial ventures, and therefore the local people are not getting anything, okay? What the Donald Trump is actually doing at the global scale, okay? So the same thing. Now, if you see apparently, it means that it's a good news for at least they are fighting within themselves. They are at least protecting three tribals, at least getting united for one particular cause. But this is not true, okay? This is actually the reflection of, again, the internal conflict. How I tell you, this is actually when they are, jab ye criterias banayenge ki who will be the Manipuri people, insiders and outsiders, they are coming up with one particular yes, criteria, saying that, say, for example, 1951 onwards, jiska registration hoga, wo Manipur people honge. Aur unko pata hai ki Naga aur Kuki tribal hilly ke paas to documents waise hi nahi hai. Theek hai? So the moment this will be applied, the Kuki and Naga will be out of the, that they are so-called no Manipuri people. तो उनको वैसे ही खदेड़ दो बाहर, ठीक है? या फिर the kind of the facilities and the protectionist measure that they are going to take, it is going to get benefited to the Maitis. Okay, so this was also a ploy on part of the dominant section by just putting up ILP across it, but there are certain internal politics to it also. Okay, so the context has to be understood by two ways. One is what is it is apparent, and what is the real. Okay, and because of this, the government of India is not granting it. Apart from that also, there are contentious issues for the internal people, that Naga and the Kukis are not so very comfortable because they see that the criteria that is going to be come into being for the determination of the Manipuri people will be actually make them difficult to be a resident of the Manipur. Apart from that, what do you think that about the idea of ILP? Forget about this. Let's say about there is no internal issue. What are the pros and cons, if at all? ILP is a good idea. Why? Why you push wrong? Other states will also do. Apart from that, us state ke liye kyun? Is there any constitutional right? Yes, haan, bataya hi tha, okay. Article 19, see, it comes in conflict with Article 19, freedom of speech and expression, and then association, then movement, then residence, etc. That is a direct conflict with Article 19. Apart from that, it's not that the outsider, when come, they exploit only, okay. Aise nahi hai ki matlab wahan pe koi jatra laga hua hai ki leke hi chale jayenge. Okay, they will work there, they outsiders. It's a history that in everywhere, wherever the people coming from outsiders, they also has a stake in development of the particular region. And mostly when there are a tribal region, like sab mein phir wo aa jayega. Jaise aap 370 mein dekho, hum hamesha bolte hai ki because there are restrictions, so the development is not happening. So in case of this, anywhere if you see this problem, like people from the Syria are migrating to the Europe, and lot many times we are seeing that there are refugees and there is a burden on the Europe, but that's not so true, because the Syrian people who are traveling, they are also very well educated professional people. They are from the IT sector. They are not from the Afghanistan and Pakistan, who are utterly a tribal people who have not been educated. Okay, these people are carrying the apple in their hands and then moving into the Mediterranean Sea and then getting caught. So, and then there is a aging problem for the Europe. So Germany aur usme kafi sara workforce ka deficiency hai. So these people going to go there and they are going to become an important workforce for the European countries, particularly in the time where the Europe is aging. Okay, so unke paas workforce ki kami hai. So that's not an always and correct argument that when the outsiders enters, it means that they do not, they are only eating up the resources. Okay, there can be different arrangements which can be made so that the protection of interest of the local community can be also be taken into account. And then second is, like, again, it is opening a Pandora's box. So if you give the grant ILP here, then obviously there will be a cascading effect. Some other tribal, some other community will also start asking for the same. So India is a homogenic whole. So wo to state becomes the different countries. Okay. Europe mein countries ke beech mein Schengen visa hai. You can travel across the countries. Yahan pe jo hai state ke andar hi itni sari problem hai. Okay, so there are a lot many things. So just write that, kya likha hai aapne abhi tak? Yes, Manipuri. Manipuri are demanding the ILP in order to protect and preserve there. Naga and the Kuki, like contentious issue karke likho, contentious issue. Contentious issue or controversy. Naga, Kuki, and other hilly tribes are not very supportive of this as they feel as they feel. It is a ploy by Maiti's faction, as they feel. ILP is a ploy by Maiti's faction, in order to increase their domination, domination within Manipur. They feel the criterias for determination of so-called Manipuri people will going to be a stringent one, which will make them difficult to take the benefits out of ILP. तो उसमें क्या करेंगे, वो बोलेंगे कि इनसाइडर्स के लिए एजुकेशन में इतनी अवेलेबिलिटी रहेगी, गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स में ऐसी अवेलेबिलिटी रहेगी, रिजर्वेशन ऐसे ऐसे रहेगा, तो काफ़ी सारा वो तैयार करेंगे क्राइटेरियाज इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोटेक्ट. बट देन दे विल पुट दैट योर 3 generation शुड पजेस द डॉक्यूमेंट्स. ओके, यू एज अ फर्स्ट, सेकेंड जनरेशन एंड थर्ड जनरेशन. अब ट्राइबल इनके पास डॉक्यूमेंट्स ही नहीं है, ठीक है. सो दैट इज गोइंग टू बी अ very difficult situation for the Naga and Kuki. But otherwise, so ILP has two angles, you must understand. One angle is Manipuri people as a whole versus outsiders. See, that's also true to some extent, that outsiders are coming and eating. So some merit is there. So that is one issue. And second issue is the perception with regard to ILP. Okay, that is ILP kaise honi chahiye uske upar. So there may be a possibility of ILP in the future, where the Naga and Kukis tribes things can be taken into consideration in order to preserve the larger interest of the Manipuri people. That's also can be possible, where they can say that, okay, we will dilute some of the criterias. So it can be an insider versus outsiders also. Okay, but as of now, it seems to be the intention of increasing the domination of the Maitis. In fact, ILP grant nahi kiya gaya tha, to inhone 3 laws laye the state assembly mein. Okay, that's not important as of now because that have been already rejected. To 3 law ye the ki inhone kya kiya ki government ne ILP nahi diya. To government mein ILP nahi diya, to ILP mein jo likhna tha inhone 3 law separate la diya. Okay, who will be the Manipuri people? Who can have the shops and this thing? Shop law, entrepreneurship law and Manipuri people law. ऐसे 3 law लाए उन्होंने. अब यह है कि ये law जो है president तक चले गए, क्योंकि वहाँ पर जो भी law commercial interest और उसको hamper करते हैं, तो the governor has reserved it for the consent of president. And the presidents knew that why they are so much concerned about these 3 laws. So again, the president has rejected all the 3 laws. सो वो रिजेक्ट हो गया, तो फिर नागा ब्लॉकेड चालू हो गया. सो कुछ ना कुछ होते ही रहता है, ये आपको समझना है. इसका रिफ्लेक्शन बहुत अलग अलग जगह पे दिख जाएगा आपको. ओके, एट एनी पर्टिकुलर इश्यू यू विल सी द रिफ्लेक्शन. ओके, हाँ, यस. परसीव्ड एंड रियल बोथ. ओके, रियल ये है कि कहीं ना कहीं उनको लग रहा है कि पहले जो है जॉब्स में इनका एक भी लोग नहीं थे, अभी 10 आ गए. अब ये रियल भी है. और परस्यूड ये है कि 100 में से 10 आ गए, तो आपको लग रहा है कि आप मर ही गए, मतलब एकदम ही यू गॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड. सो एंड हाउ डज इट मैटर्स. इनफैक्ट अर्लियर देर वॉज ए इनजस्टिस, नाउ द जस्टिस इज हैपनिंग, बट फ्रॉम यूअर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इट इज इनजस्टिस फॉर यू. ठीक है, they are implicitly, but they know that they are not going to get it, because I have yesterday explained that the criteria for the ST and their historic background vakira. Yes, unka kehna to yahi hai ki hame bhi ST status grant kar do. Theek hai, so that's the issue all about. Okay, yes. Which mixed faction? माइटी ट्राइब्स ओके. हाँ वो तो मतलब सालों साल से, वही तो मैं बोल रहा था, वैष्णवाइट उनका 100 साल पहले कन्वर्जन हुआ था. सी व्हाई विल दे कम अप विद द क्राइटेरिया वेयर दे देमसेल्व्स आर नॉट ओके विद इट. यस यस सर्टनली दे आर वेरी डोमिनेंट, दे आर वेरी ऐसे ट्राइबल. माइटी ट्राइब बोला जाता है लेकिन है नहीं, मतलब मीना ट्राइब है वो समझो उस वहाँ की. ओके ऑब्वियसली ओके विदाउट एनी बट डू नॉट टेक इट अदरवाइज. ओके यस गो अहेड विद द नेक्स्ट वन नाउ. पूरा का पूरा स्टेट ही उनका असेंबली में 95% लोग आर फ्रॉम माइथिस फैक्शन. अरे इंडिया में डेमोक्रेसी में नंबर मैटर्स, ठीक है 51 है तो खत्म है, अच्छे दिन आ रहे वहां पर. तो वो डिसाइड करेंगे ना कि मणिपुर के लिए क्या है. बिकॉज इन स्टेट असेंबली में बेसिकली इट इज स्टेट गवर्नमेंट का रूल चलता है, नंबर मैटर्स इन डेमोक्रेसी. सो दैट्स हाउ, दैट्स वाई वी से दैट इन गुड गवर्नेंस हमने बताया था कि वेलफेयर ऑफ ऑल मीन्स इंक्लूसिव एंड इक्विटी क्राइटेरिया हैज़ टू बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट. बिकॉज इसेंशियली इन डेमोक्रेसी डिसीजन आर मेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मेजॉरिटी, बट डिसीजन शुड बी मेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कंसेंसस ओरिएंटेशन रादर देन द मेजॉरिटी. ओके यस सो दैट्स द थिंग. और इनके रिप्रेजेंटेशन वहाँ पे ऐसी कोई बहुत ज़्यादा डेमोक्रेटिक इंस्टीट्यूशनल मैकेनिज्म्स नहीं है कि जहाँ पे ग्रीवेंस रिड्रेसल, सिविल सोसाइटी, एक्टिविज्म एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. देर आर अदर प्लेटफॉर्म्स. डेमोक्रेसी, थ्राइविंग डेमोक्रेसी क्या होती है कि वहाँ पे बहुत सारे इंस्टीट्यूशनल मैकेनिज्म हैं, ग्रीवेंस रिड्रेसल मैकेनिज्म है, देर आर वेज थ्रू विच द सिविल सोसाइटी मेक इन पार्टिसिपेशन, सोशल मीडिया एक्टिव है, मीडिया एक्टिव है. सो दीज आर नॉट द थिंग्स एंड दे आर माइनर इन नंबर. So either you should have a power within the assembly where your voice counts, or you should have some active pressure groups. Okay, pressure groups in the form of like where you can make your opinion count. Okay, interest group, pressure groups, media, etc., where you can force upon them in order to accept it. The only thing they have is arms and ammunition and guns and bullets. So they are blockade. So ek hi unke paas hai aur wo itna deadliest weapon hai कि पूरा का पूरा मणिपुर पैरालाइज हो जाता है. ठीक है, अब जैसे नागालैंड ब्लॉकेड, तो वो ब्लॉकेड ही है. तो हमेशा आप देखना ये गूगल में नागालैंड ब्लॉकेड डालोगे तो हज़ारों ब्लॉकेड आ जाएंगे पिछले 60 साल में. ब्लॉकेड ही उनका हथियार है. ओके सो दैट्स द थिंग. यस नाउ लेट्स कम टू नेक्स्ट, दैट इज मणिपुर हो गया. यस दिस वेयर प्राइमरीली द थ्री थिंग्स. ओके अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द लिटिल बिट ऑफ त्रिपुरा एंड लिटिल बिट ऑफ Mizoram, but in both the cases almost the problem has come to an end. But sometimes it happens that you may be asked if the problem has ended in Mizoram, why can't it end in the rest of the other states? If it has ended in Tripura, why it cannot be ended in others? So again, something like what we have discussed in case of Andhra Pradesh model. So we are going to discuss the success stories of Mizoram and Tripura. Okay. सो राइट सम मिजोरम में बस थोड़ा सा हाईलाइटेड पॉइंट्स आपको याद रखना है, बहुत ज़्यादा यहाँ पे नहीं कुछ डिस्कस करना है. मिजोरम में सी मिजोरम में इंसर्जेंसी थी और देर वॉज अ पर्सन कॉल लाल डेंगा. ओके मिजो नेशनल फ्रंट था हिस्ट्री में एंड द पर्सन कॉल लाल डेंगा. मिजो नेशनल फ्रंट, दिस वॉज अ इंसर्जेंसी बाय मिजो नेशनल फ्रंट and the person called Lal Denga. Now obviously their demand was separate Mizoram and etc. Mizo tribe ke liye separate Mizo country and armed rebellion continued. So history mein bahut jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. Now how the success, how they have scripted the success. See, there are certain peculiar points which were with respect to the Mizoram. The first important point was it was a Mizo tribe, एक ही tribe जो dominant tribe है वहाँ पे. ठीक है, और Mizo National Front was undisputed representative of Mizo tribes. Lal Denga was undisputed leader. Now आप कहोगे कि नागा में भी एक ही tribe है वैसे देखा जाए तो. ठीक है, but नागा में NSCN है, NSCN IM है, NSCN K है, NSCN KK है, so there are lot many things. तो यहाँ पे ऐसा नहीं था, यहाँ पे एक ही फ्रंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है और एक ही अनडिस्प्यूटेड लीडर है, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ देम, ओके 90% ऑफ द पीपल आर रैलिंग बिहाइंड द लालडेंगा। इन केस ऑफ आसाम में, और इधर क्या प्रॉब्लम है, इन केस ऑफ आसाम में बहुत सारी ट्राइब्स है, ओके आसाम का डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम है, बोडो का डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम है, कर्बी ऑंगलोंग का डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम है, दिस कामतापुर का डिफरेंट प्रॉब्लम है, सो देर आर लॉट मेनी अदर कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग थिंग्स। नागा में और एक प्रॉब्लम था कि नागा की जो डिमांड है वो दूसरे स्टेट्स को भी टच होती है, ठीक है। मणिपुर में बहुत सारे ट्राइब्स है, उनके अगेन कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग प्रॉब्लम है। तो यहाँ पे आपको ये समझना है कि दैट इज देर वॉज अ मिजो ट्राइब, देर वॉज अ वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड अनडिस्प्यूटेड लीडर, दिस इज अ वन पर्टिकुलर रीजन। सेकेंड, नाउ व्हाट हैज हैपेंड, हाउ दिस इंसर्जेंसी केम टू एन एंड, इन 1986 देर वॉज अ साइनिंग ऑफ मिजो अकॉर्ड, मिजो अकॉर्ड। नाउ वी हैव ऑल्सो स्टेटेड दैट most of the times the central government leadership is actually doing the politics, okay, by not resolving the problem and get the ball rolling, so for the party politics. But if you see this 1983-84, okay, there was the assassination of Indira Gandhi, and there was Rajiv Gandhi was the accidental prime minister, so he was not politics hi karna hai, to aisa nahi tha unka, wo jo tha ki approach tha ki jahan jahan pe bhi इश्यूज चल रहे, लेट्स रिजॉल्व वट एवर, द फुल वट एवर द लोकल पीपल वॉन्ट्स विद इन द फोर वॉल्स ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, एक्सेप्ट सेसेशनिज्म, वट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड वी कैन होल्ड हार्टेडली। सो इफ यू सी दैट देर वॉज अ पंजाब अकॉर्ड वॉज साइन, देर वॉज आसाम अकॉर्ड वॉज साइन, देर वॉज अ मिजो अकॉर्ड वॉज साइन, दैट वॉज द टाइम वेयर डिफरेंट अकॉर्ड्स वेर साइंड, ओके ऑल दो दोज अकॉर्ड्स, लाइक इन केस ऑफ श्रीलंका ऑल्सो, ऑल दो इट हैज led it into a very different situation altogether, but he was a sort of a person who wanted that once the law and order and peace will be established, then only can we can look for the development. So this was the time where central government leadership has a strong will in order to resolve the problem within the four walls of constitution. So aapka dushman bhi tayar hai wahan pe specific, and the central leadership is there. And the third important aspect, those who were the civilian leaders. Now, in any country, there, any state, there will be an insurgent and there will be an some civilian and the democratic leaders. So, in fact, those democratic leaders, which were quite popular during that time, in fact, it is the sagacity and the vision of those democratic leaders that they have made the way for the Laldenga, for the larger interest of Mizoram. Okay, so it's a very visionary sort of thing that you make a way for a criminal in the larger interest, because there was a direct deal. Now what was the deal here? You give up your arm and become a chief minister. Okay, jaise hota na bachpan mein ki jo zyada shararat kar raha hai usko hi class ka monitor bana de, okay aap hi ho, ab wo usko hi naam likhne ke liye bolte kaun shararat kar raha hai. So sort of that type ki aap hi insurgent mein involve ho, and you have been given the responsibility of maintaining the peace and order, so obviously it has to be there. So the three factors which are responsible for resolution of the Mizo is, one is with respect to that was Laldenga was undisputed leader, MNF was an undisputed organization, and he was ready to concede to the demand. Second was the strong leadership, central leadership, and they have a strong will in order to resolve the problem, and they come up with the flexibility. And the third was the local democratic leaders have made the way in order to for the larger interest of the Manipuri people. So these three factors have contributed, and Laldenga immediately become a chief minister. He has given up the arms. So this is a very famous story. It is not only in India, but across the world, it is very famous model that when you have a very strong will at the center, when you have a good leadership at local level, and when you negotiate with the insurgent, insurgency can come to an end. From 1987, there has not been a single event, like last 20 years, significant event in the Mizoram. It's the most peaceful state of the Northeast. Okay, so that's about it. So case study aayi to aapko batana hai ki kya kya factors hai, how the leadership, visionary, dialogues, and a good package, obviously. A good package is that is in the form of, yes. Here also it is important to understand, you have not only ended the insurgency, but you have mainstream those people into the democratic process. Okay, it's not that like in case of Andhra Pradesh we have said it is more about the guns and bullets that you have used on the security aspect. So that was not an elimination of problem altogether, it was about just the shifting of problem. Here it is because you have made them into the mainstream. But again, you have to also understand why it cannot be replicated. Okay, because I have mentioned the problem. Now come to the Tripura. Okay, what is the Tripura success story? Yes, there are problems because there are different, like Taliban is there, ISI is there, civilian leadership is weak, and army is there, yes, certainly. So there are no actually one power center, so it's difficult for negotiating. Yes, certainly. Yes, now come to this Tripura. Now, Tripura case is quite different from this. Tripura mein kya tha ki ye yahan pe National Front of Tripura. Okay, so National Liberation Front of Tripura, NLFT, National Liberation Front of Tripura. और इसका आर्म्ड विंग था ऑल त्रिपुरा टाइगर फोर्स. इसका आर्म्ड विंग था ऑल त्रिपुरा टाइगर फोर्स. दिस वॉज अ आर्म्ड विंग. एक ही है, एनएलएफटी का ही पार्ट है, दैट इज अ आर्म्ड विंग है. सो इवन इफ यू रिमेंबर एनएलएफटी, इट इज फाइन. नाउ एनएलएफटी द सेम, दैट इज दिस वॉज अ आर्म्ड इंसर्जेंसी इन केस ऑफ त्रिपुरा. Now, why it has become a success story and it's more or less a peaceful state in the northeast. Here, it's completely different. There were obviously people supporting this insurgency, but over a period of time, what has happened? The democratic leadership. So there are two governments actually running. One is the democratic leader, chief minister, and these people, and second is this armed rebellion. So democratic leadership becomes so popular because of the measures that they have taken. It's a sort of a welfare model that they have adopted for the people. So we have seen that underdevelopment is a breeding ground from extremism, and development is an antidote to extremism. So he has developed the state, and he has in fact worked for the tribal people. In fact, that was one of the socialist government, only socialist government that exists in India, I think, in Tripura or Kerala. Okay, so this was under the leadership of Manik Sarkar. So Manik Sarkar, democratic government, has adopted the welfare model, and they have resolved all the issues of the tribal community. Now what has happened over a period of time, the saints prevails, and these people who were supporting the insurgent groups, they started realizing, those people, the local cadre, that there is a pragmatism here, okay, that if you rally behind the democratic government, then it is far more good for us. And they started supporting the Manik Sarkar. Now the point is, they have not been eliminated by guns and bullets and etc. Simply the people have started supporting them, and since people have started supporting them, so nobody is asking them, obviously. So although it exists, but log hi nahi hai. जैसे आप सड़क पे चल रहे हो तो हजार ऐसे चाहिए लोग आपको, मतलब आजू बाजू में, तभी दिखेगा कि हाँ भाई कुछ, मतलब तोहफे जो बोलते हैं. तो यहाँ पे है कि इट इज़ एग्जिस्टिंग बट नोबडी इज़ आस्किंग. सो दिस अगेन अ वेरी यूनिक मॉडल वेयर अ डेमोक्रेसी इज फंक्शनिंग. ओके, दे कैन ऑल्सो हेल्प इन कंट्रोलिंग द इंसर्जेंसी विदाउट गन्स एंड बुलेट. सो वी हैव द टू सेपरेट केसेस. वन इज वेयर यू हैव मेड द निगोसिएशन विद द आर्म्ड लीडर, and here the democratic government adopting the welfare model and making the insurgency redundant and forcing the people to shift their loyalty from the supporting the insurgent leader to the supporting the democratic government. Okay, so sometimes these questions are asked, that is, what are the two successful case studies? It is like something where we see that in case of particularly in case of Assam and Tripura, Assam, Manipur and Nagaland. Okay, so the insurgency still continued. Apart from that, Meghalaya mein ek Garo National Front hai. Okay, so the Garo National Front is quite active. Kabhi kabhi here and there stray events hote rehte hai. Okay, so that's the last point. Also, you should remember that in the recent times, the Maoists have developed the linkages with NSCN, and they are also cooperating with each other, that is ULFA, NSCN. So there has been also the linkages that has been developed with the Maoist. So this is about it, about the Northeast issue. Now write the counter strategy. ओके, काउंटर स्ट्रेटेजी कुछ यहाँ पे स्पेसिफिक नहीं बताना है, सेम आप पॉइंट यूज करने हैं, सिक्योरिटी एंगल, डेवलपमेंटल एंगल, डायलॉग्स, परसेप्शन मैनेजमेंट, जस्ट एक एक लाइन लिख लो सबका। सिक्योरिटी एंगल, सिक्योरिटी प्रिपेयर्डनेस और सिक्योरिटी एंगल। सिक्योरिटी एंगल में आपको ये याद रखना है कि जो इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी है दैट इज़ अ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ आसाम राइफल्स। ओके, सो आसाम राइफल्स हैज़ अ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू मैनेज द इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी सिचुएशन। सो यहाँ पे एक छोटा सा क्रिटिसिज्म है कि आसाम राइफल्स को डुअल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है। ओके, वन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज़ टू मैन द इंडो म्यांमार बॉर्डर ऑल्सो एंड टू मैनेज द इंटरनल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स ऑल्सो। बिकॉज ऑफ द डुअल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इट इज़ बींग सेड दैट नाइदर दे आर एबल टू मैनेज द इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी दैट इज इंसर्जेंसी प्रॉब्लम्स, नॉर दे आर एबल टू बेटर गार्ड द बॉर्डर्स। एंड सिंस गार्डिंग ऑफ द बॉर्डर इज नॉट देयर, सो इनफैक्ट इट हैज़ एन रिपरकशंस ऑन द इंटरनल इंसर्जेंसी ऑल्सो, बिकॉज द फ्री फ्लो ऑफ द इंसर्जेंट अक्रॉस द बॉर्डर इज वेरी ईजी। लाइक वेन एवर यू टेक द एक्शंस दे एंटर इन टू द म्यांमार एंड फाइंड द सेफ हेवन्स देयर। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, फॉर द टेररिस्ट टू रिमेन एक्टिव यू रिक्वायर अ फाइनेंशियल एंड द लॉजिस्टिक सपोर्ट। सो दिस ड्रग ट्राफिकिंग, आर्म्स ट्राफिकिंग इज व्हाट इज द शेड्यूल फॉर द टुडे ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम टॉपिक आफ्टर दिस थिंग, वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल देयर। ठीक है, सो इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि एक दिलीप भटनागर कमेटी थी, उन्होंने सजेस्ट किया था कि देर हैज़ टू बी अ वन बॉर्डर वन फोर्स। वी विल सी दैट इन बॉर्डर मैनेजमेंट में। बस यहाँ पे लिखो कि इनको जो है वन बॉर्डर वन फोर्स चाहिए और इनको स्पेसिफिक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी देनी चाहिए। इफ़ यू आर गिविंग देम द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी देन इट हैज़ टू बी ओनली वन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, और जिसको गार्ड बॉर्डर करने के लिए ले रहे हो उनको केवल वो चाहिए, अदरवाइज देर इज़ अ लैक ऑफ फोकस ऑफ अटेंशन। अंडरस्टूड? सो दैट्स द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट। बाकी रेस्ट ऑफ द पॉइंट्स विल बी देर, देर शुड बी अ बेटर कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन द सेंट्रल फोर्सेज एंड द लोकल पुलिस फोर्सेज, दैट्स ऑल्सो विल बी देयर। थर्ड इशू इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू आर्म फोर्सेज स्पेशल पावर एक्ट, समथिंग हैज़ टू बी डन। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेपरेटली ऑल टुगेदर AFSPA बाद में, बट जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी सीरियस इशू इन केस ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट। ओके, ओवरऑल जो आसाम है, मणिपुर है, नागालैंड है, इनफैक्ट आर्म फोर्सेज स्पेशल पावर हैज़ कॉज लॉट ऑफ डैमेज एंड इट अगेन बिकम एन आयरन कर्टन बिटवीन द पीपल एंड द लोकल पीपल देयर। एंड वी हैव दिस इराम शर्मिला हु इज़ ऑन द फास्ट सिंस लास्ट 16 ईयर्स, एंड देर आर लॉट मेनी अदर ह्यूमन राइट वायोलेशंस ऑल्सो। देर वॉज अ नेकेड परेड बाय द वुमेन अगेंस्ट द सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेज वेयर वुमेन वॉज गैंग रेप्ड बाय द सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेज, सो दैट वॉज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द a very important event where we see that there is a blatant human right violation. So we'll discuss those points. So just remember, armed forces, unified command, AFSPA, these are the some of the issues within the security preparedness. Now second is development. Development. So that the same thing, that is if the underdevelopment is a breeding ground from extremism, so development is an antidote. Okay, if underdevelopment is a breeding ground for extremism, then development is an antidote to extremism. So in this context, development of northeast, which has not been the focus of attention for the different governments in New Delhi, there has to be a renewed interest. So is context mein recently lot many steps have been taken up. Ya aap jab bhi aap scheme karoge wo kar lena, but yahan pe ek angle hai aur ek hai India's Lucas policy. So we are seeing that India's Lucas policy is going to also help the Northeast. So Lucas through Northeast or Act is through Northeast. So initially we were developing the Lucas policy independent of Northeast, but because if you see the geography and geopolitics, you cannot have a good relationship with the Lucas countries or the East countries or Far East countries without the development of the Northeast. So in fact it has an opportunity for us to dovetail the India's activist policy with the welfare of the Northeast. Dovetail, you understand? Dovetailing is mixing them together so that they can complement each other. Because first most important thing if you want to develop a good relation with the Northeast is Lucas is development of infrastructure. So when there will be a development of infrastructure, so naturally there is going to be an development. So this is an opportunity for us. Apart from that, we have a separate department. We have Vision 2020 for the Northeast. there are lot many other वही है सब स्किल डेवलपमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट लोकल तीन चीज़ें कभी भी डेवलपमेंट आया तो याद रखो फर्स्ट इज़ फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर सेकेंड इज़ ह्यूमन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड थर्ड इज़ बेसिकली द लोकल लाइक इंडस्ट्री इंडस्ट्री अब कहीं पर इंडस्ट्री जो रहती है बिग इंडस्ट्री ऑल्सो बट इन दिस केस नॉर्थ ईस्ट में देर इज़ नॉट अ लॉट ऑफ स्कोप फॉर द बिग इंडस्ट्री बिकॉज इट इज़ अ हिली एरिया रक टेरेन ध्यान में भी रखते जाओ कि किस लिए कौन सा वो बता रहे हो कि देर आर नो इंडस्ट्रीज एंड स्टील प्लांट कैन बी क्रिएट अरे वहाँ पे मतलब कोल ही नहीं है तो स्टील प्लांट कहाँ से लाओगे आप ठीक है चिकन नेक कॉरिडोर है वी कैन नॉट बस वहाँ पे पेट्रोल देने नहीं जा पा रही है तो आप वहाँ पे जो है कोल लेके जाओगे सो दैट्स अ वेरी यूटोपियन टू थिंक सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर वेन एवर यू आर मेकिंग एन रिमार्क सो वॉट इज़ द ज्योग्राफी वॉट इज़ द कल्चरल कॉम्पोजिशन वेदर द पीपल कैन रियली गो इन टू दैट लाइक आई टी इंडस्ट्री हैज़ टू बी क्रिएटेड देयर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस नहीं है कहाँ से आई टी लाओगे वहाँ पर ठीक है सो दैट्स द थिंग सो स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड रादर देन यू शुड टॉक अबाउट वॉट इज़ द लोकल बिजनेस हैंडीक्राफ्ट एंड ट्राइबल्स रिलेटेड दोज थिंग्स हैज़ टू बी प्रमोटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड सर्टनली एज अ लॉन्ग जेस्टेशन पीरियड दैट इज एजुकेशन एंड स्किल डेवलपमेंट ओवर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम कैन बी डन ओके सो दिस इज अबाउट द होल द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्ट थर्ड इज गवर्नेंस हाँ ट्राइबल टूरिज्म परसेप्शन मैनेजमेंट में हम देखेंगे ट्राइबल टूरिज्म में दो प्रकार है एक है कि यस डेवलपमेंट के लिए हैंडीक्राफ्ट टूरिज्म इन ऑर्डर टू इंक्रीज देयर इकोनॉमिक रेवेन्यू देर इज ऑल्सो टूरिज्म फॉर द परसेप्शन मैनेजमेंट फॉर द नॉर्थ ईस्ट पीपल टू हैव दैट इज टू कम इन टू द मेन लैंड इंडिया एंड सो एज टू सी द इंडिया सो दैट देर विल बी अ मोर कल्चरल एक्सचेंज more people to people contact it is something like north east becomes a separate country for us so what we discuss in case of india and pakistan there has to be people to people contact there has to be a more free flow of culture ideas that also applied in case of north east because that sense of alienation which exists between the north east people that's also required to be paid an attention to okay so yes tourism ek angle hai development ka local tourism yes certainly Incredible India and these campaigns through which you can go ahead with. In fact, there's a very pristine beauty. That is one of the few areas where has not been yet touched by the development. Okay, so that pristine beauty we can obviously maintain and use it to our advantage for the promotion of the tourism. Okay, something like if you see in case of Bhutan, okay, they have maintained it and they have gone for the organic farming also. So they do not let the industry to come there and cutting of forests and etc. So something, people travel and go to the Bhutan because that is something you will not see their shopping malls because shopping malls sab taraf ek hi hai, ek hi uniform hai, CCD hai, ye hai, MACD hai, pizza hai, matlab ek hi sab ka system ek hi hai. So if you want to see the real natural beauty, so people will travel, people will see the dense forest, people will see the chirping of birds, people will see the some water is flowing. Ha, matlab aise poetic way mein aap dekhiye matlab. ठीक है सो दैट्स अ गुड स्पॉट टू ट्रैवल टू ऐसा नहीं है कि भूटान है गरीब देश है तो कहाँ मतलब जाएंगे ऐसा नहीं है ओके सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द थिंग्स सर्टनली वी कैन एक्सप्लोर इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट ओके एक एक बहुत ही कॉन्ट्रोवर्शियल अंडमान निकोबार में भी ऐसी चीज़ है वहाँ पे तो लोग ट्राइबल को ही देखने चले जा रहे हैं टूरिज्म के लिए ओके दीज आर द पीसेस जरावा ट्राइब्स ओके हाउ द जरावा ट्राइब्स लुक्स तो इस ये ह्यूमन राइट वायोलेशन है ओके डू नॉट लाइक कंसिडर दैट एंड द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज सेड दैट दोज हु विल बी इन्वॉल्व इन टू तो वहाँ पे जो टूरिज्म है कि दीज आर सम ऑफ द एलियन पीपल हु हैव अराइव्ड फ्रॉम सम अदर प्लानट वगैरह वगैरह तो दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ शुड नॉट बी देयर ओके दैट इज़ अ जरावा ट्राइब के देखने के लिए जाना सो येस देर आर सर्टन अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू डेवलप थर्ड इज़ द गवर्नेंस 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 में यू शुड रिमेंबर दैट इज शेड्यूल कौन सा है फाइव और सिक्स में से यस फाइव शेड्यूल फॉर द फोर पर्टिकुलर स्टेट्स दैट इज मेघालय एंड यस सिक्स फाइव इज फॉर द मेन लैंड इंडिया सिक्स इज फॉर द फोर स्टेट्स दैट इज मेघालय मिजोरम त्रिपुरा एंड देन अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट देर आर हिली एरिया काउंसिल ओके फॉर द हिली एरिया एल्सवेयर कहीं पर भी जहाँ पे भी हो सो लोकल गवर्नेंस के ऊपर थ्रस्ट देना है ओके ट्राइबल पीपल्स इन्वॉल्वमेंट हैज़ टू बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट रादर दैन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट और द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इम्पोजिंग देयर अथॉरिटी ऑन द लोकल ट्राइब्स सो दिस इज़ बेसिकली respecting the local tribals' customs and the culture, and then mixing up with the governance. Governance is not that is imposed by the central authority or by the state authority, but it has to be in sync with the, with their lifestyle, their culture, and their customary laws. Okay, so schedule ye jo hai explore kar sakte ho aap. Apart from that, governance mein we are going to discuss today this organized crime. There is a very strong syndicate. What we see there is a parallel governments are running. Okay, so basically this is also means that there is a mal governance when your government is not working. So the parallel government is also there. So that's also important. We will discuss those points. So the वो पैरेलल गवर्नमेंट क्यों स्ट्रांग है, सिविलियन गवर्नमेंट्स जो लेजिटिमेट गवर्नमेंट है वो क्यों स्ट्रांग नहीं है, उनको कैसे स्ट्रांग बनाना है, दिस आर आल्सो एस्पेक्ट इन द गवर्नेंस. देन परसेप्शन मैनेजमेंट में फर्स्ट अगेन हियर देयर इज अ रोल ऑफ आर्म फोर्सेस स्पेशल पावर एक्ट. वी हैव टू टेक सम मेजर्स इन ऑर्डर टू रिफॉर्म AFSPA, रिपील AFSPA, और इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्प्लीमेंट AFSPA देन some standard operating procedures. You should make it more humane, workable, so that there will be a more credibility to such laws. Apart from that, to curtail the feeling of alienation, so there can be obviously people to people contact with the mainland. There can be a different scholarship should be given to them so that people can come freely to the mainland India and can get education here. And there are other facilities that can be provided so that there will be a cross flow of ideas, culture, tradition, people's goods and services across the mainland India and the this thing. There is a role of the media also that I have explained, that when the flood comes there, so nobody really bothers about it. When bomb blast happened in case of Bodo and etc., again the news is not getting covered here. So these are there is a role of social media, there is a role of media, there is a role of otherwise the civilian society in order to put more attention to the northeast. Okay, in fact to this extent there is a lot of discrimination in mainland India about the northeast people. Okay, like say for example I have mentioned this Baranwani event and this new phase of terrorism where Kashmiri people are coming to mainland India for education, but they feel discriminated. In the same way, when the northeast people are coming to New Delhi, you see that northeast people have been targeted. In the last 2 years, there have been lot many deaths. Yes, the racial tagging is also there. Okay, so these are all such instances where there is a discrimination against the northeast. So that also has to be taken into account in the perception management. बाकी है कि leaders of northeast has to be celebrated. उनके tribals leader है. उनके ट्राइबल लीडर के स्टैचू वगैरह पार्लियामेंट के इर्द गिर्द बनाने चाहिए सो दैट दे कैन ऑल्सो कंसिडर दैट आवर पीपल आर बींग रिवर्ड एंड दे आर ऑल्सो बीन रिकग्नाइज इन साइड द मेनलैंड इंडिया. तो आप कभी पार्लियामेंट में जाओगे तो वो उनके स्टैचूज नहीं मिलेंगे उनको. सो द लोकल लीडर्स जो है, हाँ मतलब एक हाथ दो रहेंगे, बट वी नीड टू ऑल्सो रिकग्नाइज देयर हिस्ट्री, देयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल, देयर लीडर्स एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. कहाँ चले गए वो, आए नहीं है रजत कुमार कि हिस्ट्री में ये नहीं लिखा था वगैरह वगैरह. हिस्ट्री भी लिखनी चाहिए उनकी, ठीक है. तो देर हैज़ टू बी अ मोर पॉपुलराइजिंग द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल पीपल एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट इज इट इंटरनेशनल कोऑपरेशन. एक लिखिए इंटरनेशनल कोऑपरेशन, दिस इज़ वेरी मैंडेटरी हियर. International cooperation, in fact there has been a very very positive aspect with respect to international angle, because in recent time our relationship with Myanmar, Bangladesh, Bhutan and in fact China, because the economic contacts with the China has increased. These were the traditional safe havens for the terrorists. They used to train the people, they used to provide the safe sanctuaries for the insurgent groups. So the Myanmar is now moving towards the democratization. So there is a transition to democracy in Myanmar. In case of Bangladesh, yesterday I have explained that Sheikh Hasina government is there. China relationship is good. There is a whole lot of lookist and this actist angle. So this actist policy can be used to the advantage of the northeast. Okay, there are two important projects. If you want to write 2-3 important projects, so international angle mein likh sakte ho. BCIM economic corridor ek hai. So what is this BCIM economic corridor? BCIM economic corridor. So this corridor is going to pass through Bangladesh, China, India, and the Myanmar. Okay, this is from the Kolkata to Kuming. Okay, Kolkata is a part of India, so India, then it will go into the Bangladesh, then it will enter into the Myanmar, and then it will enter into the China. Okay, BCIM acronym is used, and this is not a road. Remember, this is an economic corridor. So obviously economic corridor is road will be there, but it's like a SEZ area. So in and around this, there will be a, yes, industries and lot many other economic activities will be there in and around area. So if this is passing through Calcutta and then to the Bangladesh and then some part again India, thoda sa aa jayega ye. Samajh mein aa raha hai ye map mein? Okay, some part of northeast again come, and then you come the Myanmar, and then there is a China. So this is going to spurt the economic growth in the region, and there this is a chance for India, okay, that to develop the infrastructure. There are also certain worries about this also. Worries ye hai ki jo Kuming region hai China ka, is already a developed region. Okay, once this economic corridor will get open, so the Indian market will be flooded with the Chinese atoms. Okay, pura lale lal ho jayega idhar se udhar. Theek hai? So that's also a worrisome factor that China's product going to eat up the northeast market. So for this reason, to take the maximum benefit out of this economic corridor, we should start developing the infrastructure, skill development of the people, so that we should get ourselves prepared to take the benefits from the BCIM project. But we cannot be remain optimist saying that. So obviously then nothing will move forward. Okay, so that is the China will come and etc. Yes, we can be a cautious, so what is being called as cautiously optimist. Okay, so we can take into account that there will not be a flooding of market, and whenever you come up with such kind of corridor, there are obviously rules of games. So when you become a part of that rules game, so you can also make certain protectionist arrangement to protect the local interest. Okay, so that's an important. Second is there is a multimodal project, that is a Kaladan multimodal project. Kaladan multimodal project is infrastructure development. Now this is significant because in the first I have mentioned about the chicken neck corridor, which is restricting the access to the northeast. So if you see here, this chicken neck corridor, okay, I'm just preparing for the understanding. Now this chicken neck corridor or yahan pe Bangladesh tha. Now there are two good news. One is this economic corridor, if it will be there, so here somewhere it is a Kolkata. So this economic corridor will learn. So that is also we are going to get access. Pehle thoda sa security ka region tha, jaise Khalida Zia government thi, so they were not granting the access to move. That is one thing. Again, isme bahut sara free flow to nahi hoga, but jo bhi uski conditional rahenge, wo rahenge. Second thing what we are doing is, this is if it is a Kolkata, so Kolkata se hum yahan ja rahe hain, okay, through the sea route. This Kaladan multi-project project. This is the sea route. Here it is a part of Myanmar. Okay, this is northeast. This is Bangladesh and this is Myanmar. So yahan pe ek Sitwe port hai. Okay, Sitwe port. So from Kolkata to Sitwe port, there will be a sea route. From Sitwe, there will be a river. Okay. So this river is Kaladan River. And from Kaladan River, here there will be a highway which will connect to the Murray. So there are three routes, sea route, river route, and the road. All of you are understanding? This is called Kaladan multimodal project. So we are entering into the northeast by bypassing this chicken neck corridor. Okay. So from Kolkata to Sitwe port, this is a port in Myanmar. Kolkata to Sitwe port, this is a sea route. Then from Sitwe port to some place here in Myanmar, that is the Kaladan River. So from the, this is a riverine route, and from this there will be an highway, okay, to the Murray. Murray is a place in Myanmar, nahi hai, India mein aa gaye hum. Okay, Murray is a place in Manipur or Nagaland, Manipur. Okay, Murray is a place, eastern boundary of, obviously, the very near to the Myanmar. Myanmar or Manipur ke boundary ke upar Murray karke ek place hai. So, Murray se phir hamara national highway hai. Okay, that is 37 and rest of the highways. So, wo connect ho jayega aage, second highway, jo internal highway hai. So, basically, ye humne bypass kar diya, yahan pe. To yahan se bahut sare good services ja sakte, and there is a help in development. So, you have this BCMI corridor also, and this also. This is possible only when there are international cooperation. So, international cooperation ke under, ye sab hai. Ye aapko aage bhi jo issue hai with respect to the Act East India Policy. So, Lucist or Actist, maybe. It will help in creating the infrastructure in order to get connected with the rest of the Southeast Asian countries. Okay, so this is an international cooperation. This can be, you can see international cooperation also, but it's also a part of developmental aspects. So these are all developmental aspects. This will help in curtailing the insurgency. Okay, so that has to be again. Yes, the last and the not least, we have, I think, skipped it. That is the dialogues. Dialogue, because we have this case study of this Lal Denga also. We are also having in negotiation with the NSC and IM, where we have signed a framework agreement. And we are also in different organizations. Jitne bhi organization hai, har organization ke do faction hote hai, talk faction and anti-talk faction. In fact, India has gone for this divide and rule policy also, in a sense that दो फैक्शन है तो एक के साथ टॉक चालू कर दो, फिर टॉक चालू करने के बाद और तीन चार फैक्शन हो गए और दो तीन जनों के साथ चालू कर दो. तो ऐसे 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 द नंबर ऑफ लीडर, नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु आर सपोर्टिंग विल गेट डिक्रीज, एंड दिस इज हाउ ऑल्सो देर कैन बी अ रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ इंसर्जेंसी. ओके, सो द डायलॉग इज मेन स्टे बिकॉज इट इज अ insurgency. Insurgency is a local population's armed struggle against the state. So we need to negotiate with them. The only condition is that we cannot grant the secessionism or any kind of solution. That has to be within the framework of constitution. Now within this dialogue, you can explore the options which are mentioned in the constitution. That is obviously about the autonomy. So more and more autonomy. There is a provision for something called as district council and the regional council in Schedule 6. So, Schedule 6 mein ye options hume explore karne hai, that is a regional council. See, what are these concepts? Aapne kiya hoga shayad usme. Ye state assembly hai, samjho, state legislature hai. So, state legislature is for the whole government. But there are pockets of the areas where we have the district council. So, district council mein ye, one of the district council that we have discussed is Bodo Territorial Council. So, district council is for the district or maybe the collection of districts. So, iske under jitne bhi laws hai, wo Bodo Territorial Council hi banayegi. And state laws will be only applied if the territorial council agrees to it. Then there is a concept of regional council also. Regional council is a small term in Northeast. Aisa nahi hai ki bahut sare districts se regional bana hai. It's the other way around. Within the district, you can have the smaller. Yes, because we have in the districts also, there is no uniformity in the tribe. There are small tribe. So for every tribe, in order to satisfy their political aspiration, A, and in order to protect their distinct culture and the tradition, we can go for exploring the regional council. There is also a talk for going even one step forward, that is exploring the option of village council also. In some cases, the tribes is related only with the 2 and 3 villages. So in order to satisfy their culture and their, so this is a also a unique arrangement where Indian federalism has a beauty of accepting a lot of flexibility. So within the four walls, we can meet their political demands, we can meet their cultural and social aspects, and also the development. So these are the options which can be explored through the dialogue and through the governance. Have you understood? Okay, that is the district council, the regional council, and the village council. Village council provision is not there. Okay, village council, that is something which we can think going beyond the regional council also. But again, it has been also found that in many of the cases, the district council and regional council have been created, but they are not functional. So wherever they have been created, the mandate that has been provided to them, that has to be respected. In most of the cases, it was found that state legislative assembly and the state government has a very hegemonic role with respect to this council. This is very interesting to understand in case of Meghalaya. Meghalaya mein teen hills hai, that is Goro, Khasi, Jayantia. Aur tino tribe hai, Garo tribe, Khasi tribe hai, Jayantia tribes. So tino ki alag schedule 6 ke under councils hai. Goro council, Khasi council. Aur uske baad bhi ek state hai. वैसे देखा जाए तो ये तीन छोड़ के स्टेट में है नहीं, तीन हिल्स, तीन ट्राइब और तीन काउंसिल, और एक स्टेट का भी काउंसिल है. अब वो स्टेट का काउंसिल इतना डोमिनेटिंग है कि ये तीनों के लोकल एस्पिरेशंस को फुलफिल नहीं कर रहा है. सो देयरफॉर वी हैव दिस गोरो नेशनल फ्रंट विच इज़ अगेन चैलेंजिंग द डोमिनेशन ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. सो वी नीड टू रिस्पेक्ट दैट दिस डेमोक्रेटिक डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड वी शुड रिस्पेक्ट दैट समथिंग. The structures that we have created, we should also respect their mandate. All of you have understood. So these are the options of resolving the issue of Northeast. Let us take the last point, that is framework agreement ka jo assignment tha kal ka. Kya hai? Kya? Disclose nahi kiya hai. Okay, that's the so. Kya ek hi line mein likh diya fir aapne? It has not been disclosed in public. So in fact that was the thing I wanted. Question ye nahi tha ki discuss the different features of framework agreement. In fact, because it has not been disclosed, how far we can consider that it has resolved the problem. So something which has not been disclosed. Ha, acha, aap karke aaye, chaliye. Go ahead. Yes, yesterday's, I hope everybody remembers. What was the question? That recently government of India has signed framework agreement with Naga, and which Naga? That is NSCNIM. Who both parties? Okay, ये काफी pomp and show के साथ sign हुआ था, and it was being considered that it has almost resolved the problem, Naga issue, that is 2-decade-old, 60-year-decade-old, 6-decade-old issue was resolved. So we will see and analyze. Huh? Please go ahead. Good. Okay. Recognition of culture and the history. Okay, principle we are discussing, that is recognition of unique history and culture of Naga. So this was in principle, but how it will get reflected we'll see. And dusra kya point bataya? Yes, recognition of principle of sovereignty. Yes. Pardon me again, can you come up? What you are saying? Okay, after agreement got successful, huh? मदर्स को कैसे सेटिस्फाई करोगे जब आप रिजर्वेशन ही नहीं कराने का, वो बोलेंगे ना. ओके. हाँ, नागा मदर्स एसोसिएशन एक है. मदर्स मतलब मदर्स नहीं, रिजर्व एसोसिएशन. यस्टरडे वी हैव स्पोकन अबाउट दिस रिजर्वेशन. हाँ, प्लीज गो एट. ओके. Negotiations. Yes. Okay. So it's just a matter of time that the problem is going to get over, because all the you have a very wonderful points, like optimistic points. Yes, certainly they are there. Ha, kya problems hai? Ha. Sure. Absolutely. So when the Naga issue will, we can consider that will got over. Only when all the sections will be satisfied. See, if one section is satisfied, another is continued to blow the, obviously the bomb blast and etc. So it cannot be considered as complete resolution. Second is, we will see that this was just a framework agreement. This was not also the resolution of problem. We'll discuss some more. Okay, at least we got some introduction here. Yes, huh. तो वो आने के लिए तैयारी नहीं है ना वही तो इशू है स्टेकहोल्डर के लिए प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज सेंड द दिस टू खाफलांग के लिए खाफलांग ने बोला हमें नहीं बात करनी है हमारे कमांडर से बात करो सूवी से तो वो अपसेट हो गए कि हम यहाँ पे पूरा डेमोक्रेसी का लीडर वहाँ पे आ रहा है और आप बात नहीं करने के लिए तैयार है सो खाफलांग इज इन नो मूड टू टॉक विथ ओके बिकॉज ओके They are not supporting. Okay, what else? Yes, good. Yes, any new point apart from what he has mentioned? It was a good introduction, by the way. ठीक है. Okay, good. Yes, yes, good. See that, okay, I'll come. Yes. Achha, kya aapne discuss kiya hai? How, what you have whispered in the ear? We don't know. Yes, certainly. People do not know about what the leaders are discussing. Somebody is whispering in the ear and saying that problem has been resolved. But what you have whispered, people do not know about it. Whether the sovereignty has been accepted, whether the Naga has been given the status, nothing has been in the public domain. Because nothing was there. The very issue was, it was a framework. Ki hum is principle ko leke baat karenge. There was nothing like give and take and this we have agreed upon. We have agreed upon, we will continue to talk and resolve the problem. Okay, so we will discuss those points. Yes, good. Yes, good. Good. Yes. But 371A, we have this arrangement. Yes, you have a point. Good. At least work to kiya, isliye good bola hai. Matlab, yes. Nahi, nahi. Don't take the otherwise. Take it. If you can be allowed, then you can read whole answer. Online logon ko bhi jana chahiye aapki awaaz. Okay, very good. Very good. Yes. Yes. Okay, good. To have a dialogue. Okay, good. Hmm. Yes. Which filling? AFSP. Okay, fine. When it is not public, how can you say that AFSP has not been mentioned and other are not mentioned? No, they just said, nahi, I'm just saying, you have making a statement that nothing is made in public domain. Okay, theek hai, fine, go ahead. It's fine. Okay, ठीक है, good. You can you be a negotiator between the Naga and the government of India? Because sounds very good. कौन है interlocutor? Yes, Aryan Ravi. Aryan Ravi is the interlocutor currently. हाँ, yes. हाँ, new points. हाँ, बताइए. हाँ हाँ ठीक है, way forward बताइए. फ्लड लाइट एकदम से. गुड, वेरी गुड. शेयर्ड सॉवरेनिटी इज अ प्रिंसिपल दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन वे फॉरवर्ड. ओके, फाइन, गुड. यस, एनी न्यू पॉइंट? हाँ, यस, वेरी गुड. व्हाई यू हैवंट मेंशन देन? अच्छा, यू फॉरगॉट. ओके, यस. सो लेट्स सी दैट. सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव मेंशन, थोड़ा सा हिंट भी दिया था कि तीन उसमें डिस्कस करना है कि व्हाट इज दिस ऑल एग्रीमेंट अबाउट. सो लिटिल बिट ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑन दैट. Then some of the positive, that is a pros, and then some cons, and then last is the way forward. So you can divide it into the four different parts. That is, what is this agreement in terms of the introduction of the agreement and what all is about. Second is pros, that is, what are the positives of agreement. Then, rather than calling it cons, it is more of a challenges. Okay, challenges, that is, how far we can conclude that it was a historic agreement and has resolved the problem. And then we can say what is a way forward if there are lot many challenges. This is important because this is a significant peace deal that we are coming with the different groups, and this is the most significant group because for last 60 years NSCN is fighting, although it was initially called as NNC, that is a Naga National Council under Dr. Fizo yesterday, if you remember. Okay, now introduction mein ye hai. First of all, see, the name is framework agreement. So framework agreement ka naam hi hai ki aapne keval framework bana diya hai. That is, this is a framework within which we are. So this is not a final solution. This is not a final solution of the document. So you can say that this is a framework agreement which has been signed between the government of India and the NSCN IM. And see, before this, there was 1997 mein suspension of operation pehle sign kiya hua tha. Suspension of operation is ceasefire. Okay, now from ceasefire to this 2015, it took almost 18 years to sign the framework. Now, we are not knowing how far it is going to take the on the solutions. समझ में आ गया? सो 18 इयर्स यहाँ पे फ्रेमवर्क एग्रीमेंट. बट अब पॉजिटिव पॉइंट्स में आ जाओ. सो फर्स्ट, यू मेंशन दैट दिस वाज अ फ्रेमवर्क एग्रीमेंट एंड यू कैन से दैट दिस वाज अ सिग्निफिकेंट स्टेप, सिग्निफिकेंट फर्स्ट स्टेप और सिग्निफिकेंट इनिशियल स्टेप इन ऑर्डर टू रिजॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ नागा. at least government has shown the willingness in order to resolve the problems. They are engaging the insurgent groups. Because we have been having this tendency in order to bring the Naga people to the negotiating table. So one of the armed wing which are bringing to the negotiating table, so certainly it's a significant step. And this is a framework agreement. And this framework agreement, so write little bit, that is, the framework agreement mein bahut details bahar nahi aaye, lekin we know the principles, that the principles like respecting any solutions will be with respect to the respecting the history and the culture of the Naga. And second point, Gata? Yes, sovereignty will be also be taken into account. Okay, so these are the two important things you can mention. Now, having mentioned this, that a good start has been made, but you can see that, but it is not correct to call as an historic agreement because there are lot many challenges. So in fact, challenges are many. So different challenges you have to write. So first challenge itself, first of all, you should mention this is a framework agreement. And framework agreement, this is not a final agreement, so it is going to take a time. Second thing is to resolve sabse important problem unka kya hai ki sovereignty chahiye. So is India going to grant the sovereignty? Okay, so that question has not been addressed yet within the framework agreement. We will discuss in way forward mein, it can be a shared sovereignty. But what is, where are the government has going to accept the greater Nagaland demand of the Nagaland? That has not been. So within the NSCM IM also, we haven't, I am ye nahi bol raha hai ki hamara satisfy ho gaya, ab tum Khaflang ko engage karna hai. Even IM has not yet been satisfied. IMF has just started talking with the government. Quite possible that they will remain on the hard stand, their radical stand, and will not give up on that. So sovereignty principle ke upar jab ho jayega, tabhi aa jayega. So that's the first challenge. Second challenge is NSCN, IAM, Khaflang and KK. Most important, obviously, these are the new organizations. So Khaflang faction has basically rejected this agreement, and they are saying that their struggle for the sovereign Naga limb will continue. Okay, so first agreement, abhi hame pura detail pata nahi hai. Second is NSCN Khaflang has outrightly rejected it. Third thing, important, greater Naga limb mein kon kon si state aa raha hai? Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, and the Myanmar. So, chief ministers of Assam and Manipur, Assam, Manipur has already stated that any kind of agreement which will hamper the territory, okay, which will have a larger consequence, because it has also not been clear whether this Naga part going to get cut and get added into the Naga, because the agreement is silent about whether the territorial integration of Naga will be there or not. Fourth thing is, that is involvement of the Myanmar. Okay, Myanmar is continued, like this Khaflang and KK is actually staying in the Myanmar. So even if you will solve the agreement, if the KK and this Khaflang will continue to get the support from the Myanmar, the insurgency will continue. So there is a need of having an engaging the Myanmar so as to eliminate the problem. This is the fourth. Now the fifth point is, there has been a new development. There has been new development, new organization has been created, that is UNFSW. That is SWA. So right, that United National Front of Southwest Asia. Okay, there has been a creation of United National Front, UNF, ye word common hai usme, kisme dekha tha, UNF, M, United National Front of Manipur mein thia? Tripura mein ye, National Front of Tripura, okay, NLFT. Okay, so this actually a front, now if you see here, this front is not a new, aise kuch naya organization nahi hai. It is actually all the organization are coming under the one umbrella. So it is a combination of ULFA, NDFB, KLO, NSCN, कौन सा फैक्शन रहेगा यहाँ पे? काफलांग फैक्शन, एंड देन यू हैव UNLF, दैट इज यूनाइटेड नेशनल लिबरेशन फ्रंट ऑफ मणिपुर, PLA. सो दीज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैव केम टुगेदर अंडर वन अम्ब्रेला बिकॉज द गवर्नमेंट इज नाउ गेटिंग सीरियस. सो ऑब्वियसली दोज पीपल हु आर not ready to give up the arms. So this has been the new development. Now here also it is important to understand the word Southwest Asia. Okay, United National Liberation Front of Southwest Asia. Southwest Asia mein kya lag raha hai aapko? Matlab, yes, see the thing is Southeast Asia. So they are trying to talk about that we are more a part of, yes, there particularly, that is the Southeast Asia ka western part hai. So this is something that is a very worrisome factor that these people are getting together in order to like something what we have discussed in case of Naxalism, CPI Maoist karke ek organization tha. To yahan pe waise hi hai. So this is we have to take into account. So there are many challenges. So you can see that yes, this is a step in a right direction, but there are certain challenges. That details of framework is not ready. The Khaflang faction is not ready. There is no point with respect to whether the greater Nagalim demand has been accepted and whether there is a really integration of different geographical parts of different states. And if at all geographical parts will be integrated, what will be the situation within these three states? So they also start like there will be a very difficulty in meeting this demand. And fourth is this. So in this context, we can see that there are more challenges ahead. And we have to take also into account this. This also is a good opportunity for us to understand what are the different problems. Okay, it's not just a simple problem. There are lot many complications. Now, write the way forward. What is the way forward then? Now, first, yahi se hum karte hai ki way forward yahan pe jo hai, फ्रेमवर्क एग्रीमेंट में हमने बोला कि शेयर सॉवरेनिटी के ऊपर क्या रहेगा. सी वी विल नॉट एबल टू ग्रांट द सॉवरेनिटी टू देम, कंप्लीट सॉवरेनिटी जिसको बोला जाता है, नॉर दे आर गोइंग टू एक्सेप्ट लेस देन द सॉवरेनिटी. सो देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड शेयर्ड सॉवरेनिटी. शेयर्ड सॉवरेनिटी मतलब दोनों की सुप्रीमेसी रहेगी, दैट वी विल रिस्पेक्ट यूर हिस्ट्री कल्चर एंड एक्सेट्रा, बट वी विल यू शुड ऑल्सो एक्सपेक्ट दैट द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैज सर्टन लिमिटेशन एंड यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट the Indian, ha, larger maybe you are a part of India, but nonetheless you are completely autonomous and sovereign. So there has to be a shared sovereignty, and it's a, like a compromise, okay, that is between the win-win situation can be created between the two. Second is Khaflang faction. Yes, Khaflang faction, government of India should negotiate with them. If they are not ready to give up, you should move ahead with NSC and IM, because over a period of time people of the Naga will realize there is no point in going in the extremist direction. So whatever the options that you have, you should explore. People will realize that peace is the only way and violence is not the way in order to get, or वैसे भी significance कम हो जाएगा. See, actually इनको insignificant बनाना है तो आपको यहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा काम करना पड़ेगा. You have to make them more relevant. NSCM, IM को, डेवलपमेंट को, ग्राउंड सिचुएशन को. सो इफ यू मेक दिस डील वर्केबल ऑन द ग्राउंड, सो पीपल विल नॉट रैली बिहाइंड द खाफलांग एंड KK. सूनर और लेटर देर आर ओनली टू ऑप्शन विल बी लेफ्ट फॉर द खाफलांग, आइदर ज्वाइन द पीस प्रोसेस और गेट इलिमिनेटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. गेट इलिमिनेटेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, इट कैन बी थ्रू द इंसर्जेंसी ऑल्सो, काउंटर इंसर्जेंसी ऑब्वियसली, और बींग एन इनसिग्निफिकेंट समथिंग वट हैज हैपन इन केस ऑफ त्रिपुरा. ओके, now here what can be done? Yes, here it is next to impossible. If you are imagining that the Nagaland going to be in greater Nagaland, it is not going to happen, because any it will create a lot of problem. Why Naga has to be the only tribe? Then every tribe will have its demand. So there can be a different agreement that is giving the Naga region and Naga autonomy. Okay, जहाँ जहाँ पे ट्राइबल है, जो शेड्यूल 6 के डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल है एंड रीजनल काउंसिल एंड विलेज काउंसिल है, जहाँ जहाँ पे अभी नागा के पॉकेट्स है, रादर देन देयर फॉर्मल इंटीग्रेशन इनटू द ज्योग्राफिकल स्टेट एंड पॉलिटिकल स्टेट, दे हैव टू गिवन अ कंप्लीट ऑटोनॉमी. दे शुड बी गवर्न बाय देयर ओन कस्टम्स एंड लॉज. सो वी कैन एक्सप्लोर द ऑप्शन ऑफ डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल, रीजनल काउंसिल, विलेज काउंसिल, सो दैट द नागा पीपल विद इन द अरुणाचल प्रदेश, आसाम एंड द मणिपुर एन्जॉय द ऑटोनॉमी. समझ में आ रहा है? नहीं आ रहा है? ओके, सो देर इज नो इंटीग्रेशन, बट स्टिल दे कैन हैव देयर सी एंड there will not be a hegemony by other dominant regions. Now, with respect to this, we can see that if we are working upon them, so obviously, and development we have just now seen, once the development will be there, once the good governance will be there, they will be automatically become irrelevant. And some other way, we have also the security angle to deal with them. Also here, it requires cooperation with the neighboring countries. So we can forge the good cooperation with the Myanmar, Bangladesh, again, to work upon this in order to, in fact, this itself is a sign that now there is a fear among them that being an insignificant, something which was independently, they were thinking that we were strong enough. Now they are, they have to get together in order to challenge. Over a period of time, isme aur ek hai, is framework agreement mein ek aur positive point likha ja sakta tha yahan pe. Ek to humne government ke side se bataya ki government has taken its step forward. It is also understanding on part of NSCMIM that violence is not the way forward. Okay, 20, 30 years, 40 years, unko ye realize hua ki neither we are going to get a separate country, nor the violent is a way forward. So somewhere it is a realization on part of NSCMIM that violent methods cannot be a way forward. So that's how they are. Also, there are other issues also. Jo Isaac and Muiva tha. So Muiva, Isaac was not keeping well, recently died also. And so that was also, leadership was also understanding that we have lived, it has lived its utility, that armed struggle. NSCNIN ko ye jo hai, civilian log bhi kafi unko pressure kar rahe hai, that you need to have a peaceful negotiation because insurgency cannot continued till eternity. Okay, there has to be a certain solution. This this question is very important because you can use these points otherwise also in understanding the problem. Ek leader, do hai, Isaac and Muiva hai. I is Isaac. Okay, Isaac su kuch hai, aur Muiva. Haan, Isaac died and Muiva is there, T Muiva is there. Okay. Yes, so that's the thing. And now we can move to the organized crime. Okay, next. Yes, organized crime likho. Organized crime, its linkages with terrorism. It's both time. Okay, please. Break chahiye. Okay, take a break. Organized crime and its linkages with terrorism. Aapko economics mein black money wagera hai kya? Shall I skip the black money issue? Black money laundering. Hua hai ya nahi hua? Hua hai toh I can skip it. Okay, theek hai. वही है रहता है और क्या रहता है इकोनॉमिक्स ओके वी विल डू इट टेक अ ब्रेक जल्दी से जाओ जल्दी आ जाओ यस राइट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम Organized crime and its linkages with terrorism. So first of all, we will see what is organized crime and how it is different from terrorism. Yes, what is your understanding? Organized crime, kya rehte? Planned crime. Terrorism is unplanned one. Yes. Yes, go ahead. Planned. Groups. Legal hurdles. Easy to escape. Kaun se state se aap? Punjab? Delhi? Okay. Yes. What is an organized crime? What is your understanding? Yes, anyone? Yes, aap bataiye. Ha, you are sophisticated. Extortion is organized crime or not? No? Very good. Wide. Very good. Huh? Yes, there is some. ठीक है, crime है एक प्रकार का. किस लिए crime किया जाता है? Yes, in fact, see, we will see that how does it is different from terrorism. हाँ, these are the examples of organized crime. Human trafficking, drug trafficking, arms trafficking. हाँ, अच्छा, हाँ ठीक है. टर्माइट्स, ओके. और यहाँ यहाँ पे क्या करना रहता है इनको ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम में? फॉर्म. गुड, यू हैव अ पॉइंट. ओके, सी द टेररिज्म और उसमें डिफरेंस करना बहुत जरूरी है, एंड देन वील सी द लिंकेजेस आल्सो. ओके, इन केस ऑफ टेररिज्म violent means, okay, in order to create fear so as to achieve the political goals. Yes, political, religious, ethnic or ideological goals. Whereas in case of organized crimes, now if you see the organized crime here, violent method may or may not be. May or may not be. Okay. But certainly whatever there is, it is the illegal methods are applied. Okay, violence we cannot say, but whatever the means. Now here the means is obviously there are organized crimes, we'll see that. And what is an ultimate objective? Ultimate objective is a commercial interest. Yes, commercial interest, it is more about financial and material gain. In fact, this is the single most differentiating point, financial or material gains. Unhone dukan khol rakhi hai paise kamane ki. The only different thing with respect to the normal company and this company is, normal company goes through the legitimate mechanisms to earn the money, they go through the illegitimate means such as human trafficking, drug trafficking, yes, arms smuggling, trade's illegal trade, smuggling, okay. So, trade can be legal, illegal, okay, smuggling. Now, if you see the normal entrepreneur company, okay, they also earn the money, but through the legitimate means, okay, and they also have the financial interest. So we need to compare between the three things, that is a normal company, a organized group and terrorism. Now what is the similarity between these two? Like say yahan pe hai Infosys or yes TCS. So both of them have the same end. So it's a company. Organized group is also company and this is also company. Both have the same end, that is the commercial and the financial interest, but one applies illegitimate ways, the ways or the things which have been banned by the law, and these are the, you know, software industry kholi hai, you know, drugs or arms ki industry kholi hai. Okay, mafia, yes, there are certain other things like human trafficking, arms trafficking, gold trafficking, cattle trafficking, fake currency. Okay, there are all illegitimate activities through which they are earning the money. And this is something legitimate activity. So with respect to organized crime and company, there is a similarity that there is a very a structured, like jaise company rehti hai, yahan pe jaise D company hai. Okay. So it's also a very organized company. Both of them have the same end. So there are two things which are common to both. That is, there is an organized structure. Okay, well-planned, well-neat, organized structure. And both of them are involved in the crime, but with the different means. Now, between the organized crime and terrorism, there is a one similarity. Both are illegitimate in its means. Okay, means are illegitimate. Although violence is a different thing, but this is also illegitimate thing, and this is also illegitimate thing. But there are ends are different. इसके बाद हमें देखना है कि हाउ ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम एंड द टेररिज्म एस्टैब्लिशेस द लिंक. ओके, सो राइट नाउ व्हाट इज द ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, लिखिए, इज द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, ओके, सो राइट अ सिस्टमैटिक एंड ऑर्गेनाइज ग्रुप, a systematic and an organized group of three or more than three people, systematic and organized group of three or more than three people existing for a time, comma, getting involved in committing the serious crime, such as drug trafficking, arms trafficking, etc. एक दो ही लिखो, ओके, वो डिटेल में देखना है. दैट्स नॉट, बट जस्ट बता रहे हैं कि सीरियस क्राइम कौन सा है. ठीक है, व्हाट यू आर रिटन, कैन एनीबडी रीड इट? That yes, it is a systematic and organized group of three or more than three people getting involved in committing the serious crime in order to gain the financial and material benefits. In order to gain financial or material benefits. So in fact, there are three parts in the definition. In fact, you can put an attention here. Organized crime, ye group hai. Okay, kaun sa group hai? Three or more than three people existing for a period of time. Now, this is important to understand. So any stray event, jaise hai ki aapke paas thode paise nahi hai aur aapne ek crime kar liya, bas aapka man chalane ke liye. And then there is a change in heart. You said that mera thoda sa matlab economic crisis chal raha tha, to thoda loot part kar lete hain. And fir buddha ke matlab ha ki that crime is not good. So that's not an organized criminal activity. Okay, it's just a stray event. It has to be a long period of existence of three or more than three people. Aaj bank robbery, kal kuch, parso kuch aur, kal see piracy chalu hai, सीडी से चालू है, साइबर क्राइम चालू है, कुछ ना कुछ, या फिर एक एक्टिविटी है वो रेगुलर ही चालू है, बैंक रॉबरी कर ही रहे हो मतलब. ठीक है, सो ऑर्गेनाइज ग्रुप ऑफ थ्री पीपल और मोर देन थ्री पीपल एग्जिस्टिंग फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सेकेंड इज कमिटिंग द सीरियस क्राइम्स सच एज ड्रग ट्राफिकिंग, आर्म ट्राफिकिंग, ह्यूमन ट्राफिकिंग इन ऑर्डर टू गेन द कमर्शियल इंटरेस्ट. सो थ्री पार्ट्स ऑफ डेफिनेशन इज ग्रुप, सो राइट, देर आर थ्री पार्ट्स इन द डेफिनेशन. There are three aspects or three parts in the definition. That is, first is organized group of three or more than three people. Organized group of three or more than three people existing for a time. Second, illegitimate activities or committing the serious crime having a punishment of at least 4 years. Committing a serious crime or the heinous crime, having a punishment of at least 4 years. Next is, the crime is committed. Crime is committed primarily for the commercial interest. Crime is committed primarily for the commercial interest. Commercial interest. There is a financial or the material gain. These parts, these three parts, there is a United Nations transnational organized crime. Iske teen feature hai jo humne dekhe abhi. So you can write, these are the three features of definition of United Nations transnational organized crime. Okay, any crime that can come under the this, it will have the three features. So you should have a three or more than three group of people for a time. A crime which is more than 4 years of imprisonment and it is done for the commercial interest. United Nations Convention on Transnational Organized Crime. Convention, see silent hai yahan pe. United Nations Convention on Transnational Organized Crime. Okay, uski definition. Now write the next, that is comparison and relation between the terrorism and organized crime. Comparison and relation between terrorism and organized crime. So first write similarities. Similarities. Okay, both of them are the illegitimate or illegal acts. Both of them are the illegitimate or illegal acts. Whether it is a violent or not, it does not matter. Okay, one is doing the violence, one is doing the crimes. Okay, both of them are illegitimate acts. Second, both of them have a good structural and institutional mechanism of its own, and both acts are well planned and systematic. ओके तो दोनों में भी स्ट्रक्चर एक वेल थॉट स्ट्रक्चर है जिनमें वो वेल थॉट प्लान स्ट्रेटजीज रहती है. सो दीज आर द टू सिमिलैरिटीज. नाउ राइट द डिफरेंसेस. डिफरेंसेस. सो फर्स्ट यू कैन राइट द टेरर एक्ट्स have the political, ethnic or religious objective. Terror act has a political, ethnic or the religious act, religious objective, whereas organized crime has a financial or the commercial objective. So that's difference in the end. Second, you can write, terrorism in most of the cases resort to violence. Because their intention is short term mein kya rehta hai, fear. In order to create fear, you can write, terrorism most of the cases resort to the violence in order to create fear, whereas violence is not a fundamental feature of organized crime. Violence is not a fundamental feature of organized crime. It is more incidental and circumstantial in nature. It is more incidental all or circumstantial. More incidental or circumstantial. मतलब क्या है कि जरूरत पड़ी तो ठीक है, अगर आपका माल नहीं जाने दे रहा है तो उड़ा दिया जाएगा, ठीक है। अगर आप पीसफुली माल जाने दे रहे हो तो कोई वायलेंस नहीं है, ठीक है। तो उनको इनोसेंट लोगों को उसको नहीं किल करना है, ठीक है, बस पैसा कमाना है। एक ऐसे दे डू नॉट हैव दिस जिहाद, इनफैक्ट दे हैव द स्टेक्स इन मेंटेनिंग द मोर एंड मोर पीस, दे वॉन्ट टू रन द propaganda by deed is not there. In fact, they want to work so secretly that nobody will comes to know about it. And here is, there is no impact unless and until people get fear out of it. So that's the difference between the two. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Okay. Right, the third. Terrorism tries to overthrow the government. Third, terrorism has an objective. Has an objective. To overthrow the government, whereas on the other hand, organized crime wants to establish parallel government. आप over the ground, हम under the ground, ठीक है? आप tax ले लो, हम extortion करेंगे. So दोनों पैसे ले रहे हैं, एक democracy के नाम के ऊपर पैसे ले रहे हैं और एक यस क्राइम से, यस कोई धंधा छोटा नहीं होता है, ठीक है, और धंधे से बड़ा कोई धर्म नहीं होता है, यस सो रईस क्वाइट एप्ट कि कोई धंधा छोटा नहीं होता है, मतलब और वो बोलता है देखो नवाजुद्दीन सिद्दीकी, जिसको आप धंधा बोल रहे हो क्राइम है, क्राइम, ओके, सो दिस इज बेसिकली वॉट यू आर इसेंशियली कंसिडरिंग धंधा, बिकॉज यू आर अर्निंग मनी बट यू आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द मीन्स, इट इज़ बेसिकली द क्राइम. So how you are actually seeing at the organized crime, your perspective matters. If you are seeing the end, you will compare yourself with simply a company, that I am also earning money and somebody else is also earning money. But the police is looking at the means. Somebody is earning the money then through the legitimate ways. So jisko aap dhanda samajh rahe ho, that is actually a crime and that has to be the focus of attention. Okay, so that's unfair trade practices, yes, certainly. Yes, so that's the thing here. You want to run a parallel government, and in fact, if you see, like say for example, in case of Mumbai, if you win this one crore, okay, कौन बनेगा करोड़पति? तो बोला जाता है कि टैक्स लगेगा और टैक्स कट के मतलब आपको 60 लाख मिलेंगे या 70 लाख मिलेंगे. लेकिन मुंबई के बाहर से निकलने तक आपको 50 और 40 लाख ही मिल सकते हैं, क्योंकि वो टैक्स 30 लाख गया और 30 लाख मुंबई से बाहर आने के लिए, ओके, खोका आपको एक फ़ोन आ जाएगा. हाँ, तो दो चार जो है परसेंटेज जो है पहुंच जाना चाहिए यहाँ यहाँ पे. अगर नहीं पहुंचा तो आप ही घर पे नहीं पहुंचोगे, ठीक है. सो दिस इज़ अ अंडरवर्ल्ड प्रैक्टिस विच इज़ वी सी द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम एंड द एक्सट्रॉशन. दे रन अंडर द गवर्नमेंट, सॉरी अंडरग्राउंड, एंड दे हैव द इमेंस पोटेंशियल इन ऑर्डर टू इन्फ्लुएंस फॉर देयर कमर्शियल इंटरेस्ट. ओके, सो दैट्स अ कंपेरिजन बिटवीन द डिफरेंसेज एंड द सिमिलैरिटीज. नाउ राइट द टॉपिक दैट इज organized crime in India, or you can oblique likho, organized crime and its linkages with terrorism in India. Organized crime in India, or oblique organized crime and its terror linkages in India. Oblique organized crime and its terror, because we are going to see this information you can use if separate organized crime is also asked, and you can use the information if the linkages are also asked. Okay, now terrorism we'll see region by region we are going to discuss. So first you can write the Northeast. Now in fact some of the general points you should remember, what must be the link in general, forget about Northeast and Kashmir and etc. How, why there is a relationship between the organized crime? What sort of relationship? Funding. Why will they fund? funding, you have to earn money by different mechanisms, money laundering, etc. Why will the somebody will earn the money? Okay, he does not have the objective of jihad. He has the objective of earning money. Mindset same hai, or see, the thing is a very simple here. Terrorism wants to create a violence, and they requires an arms and ammunitions. And organized crimes want to sell the arms and ammunition in order to earn the money. So there is a client and buyer relationship. Okay, client buyer relationship, or what we call a symbiotic relationship. Inko jo hai violence ke liye arms ammunitions khareedne padenge, aur inko organized crimes ke liye paisa kamana hai. See, the thing is, interesting factor about organized crime is they do not mind in providing the arms and ammunition to the both the parties fighting, because unke liye koi jihad nahi hai aur koi wo nahi hai, theek hai. So everything is fine in war. Okay, that's it. So the very point is they want a violence, they want a disturbances, so that a more number of stakeholders get involved into the violence and they buy the arms, etc. So this is a symbiotic relationship. Second aspect obviously is a sort of a funding, but we will see that is a slightly how it is different, and we will go region by region. Now region by region, because in case of Northeast, Naxalism, Jammu and Kashmir and elsewhere, if the terrorism in contemporary time, in the global network, if it has to exist, it requires a lot of financial support. Okay, so the terrorist elements actually themselves get involved into the organized crimes in order to earn the money. So earning the money for the terrorist, kyunki yahan se ye paise inki payment karenge, lekin paise payment karne ke liye inke paas paise bhi to lagenge. So there are two organized groups. Yahan pe hai D company, that is Daud is supplying you the arm. Okay, so this is one organized crime, but for them they have to earn the money. So they also get resort into the organized crime in order to earn the money. Once they earn the money, they supply the money. Okay, so we will see that how this terrorism in Northeast, Naxalism or elsewhere in Kashmir is surviving, and because of the organized activities, and how there is a strong linkages between the two. So if you want to break the nexus, if you want to be a successful on any one of them, you have to break the nexus between the two, because one is thriving on the partnership of the other. Okay, so if you take an action against only one, it will not be sufficient. So we'll see the Northeast mein funding kaise ho rahi hai, Northeast region, what organized crimes are happening. So there are three different ways. One is ye jo NSCN, ULFA wagera, itne sab insurgent group hai. So insurgent group in how they are earning the funding. Insurgent group in Northeast are earning the money in following ways. So obviously by getting involved into the organized crime in following ways. So first hai ki, that is directly from the people through the method of extortion, kidnapping, contract killing, supari killing bhi bola jata hai. Okay, ek dusre ke jitne bhi tribals log hai unke head ko maar dena. Okay, extortion is yes, direct chaku dikha ke de do paise. Kidnapping, ghar pe bachche ko utha ke leke jao, phone lagao, fir wo roega bachcha, fir itne itne paise, theek hai. Kidnapping, contract killing is certainly obviously sophisticated one. So this is a direct methods through which you can earn the money. Second method to earn money is they are running the parallel government. Now this is a very unique thing here. Is parallel government mein ek feature hai ki this government of India's money is getting channelized into the hands of insurgents. Now how it is happening in this case, there are different ways. One is like, say for example, the contract is being allocated. Government of India ke jo officials hai, so sadak banani hai. So sadak banane ke liye tender niklega. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. दे विल गिव अ कॉल टू द आईएएस ऑफिसर हियर, थर्ड जो है हमारा आदमी है, पैसे दे दो इनको, इनको कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अवार्ड कर दो. सो 100 करोड़ रुपीज़ का कॉन्ट्रैक्ट अवार्ड हो जाएगा, उसमें से 20 करोड़ रुपीज़ का सड़क बनाएंगे, 80 करोड़ रुपीज़ आर गोइंग इन टू द पॉकेट्स ऑफ इंसर्जेंट्स. ओके, नाउ वाई द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड देयर ऑफिशियल शुड ग्रांट दिस पर्टिकुलर थ्रू टू मेथड्स, ऑब्वियसली ब्राइबिंग ऑल्सो एंड सेकेंड इज मोर अबाउट द इंटिमिडेशन. ओके, intimidation also, and third is about there is also implicit understanding between the government of India and this insurgent. ye bolte hai ki ek 80 crore de do nahi to kal char body uthane ke liye taiyar ho ja. Okay, we are going to defuse the bomb. So it is more about choosing the bad from the worst. Okay, if you will not listen to them, they have the capacity to defuse the bomb at any point of time, any day, at any given point of time. So there is a lot of intimidation of the local government officials. So local government officials, either through the bribe, that is through the inducement, or through the intimidation, so you can write there, that is a parallel government way. Insurgents through the method of intimidation or inducement, or by offering the bribe or threat. Insurgents by offering a bribe or threat to government officials. win the contracts, and obviously with the less money they will construct and they will earn the money. This is how they are earning the money. So this is a parallel government. Which is second point is ye contract method hai, second method hai, that is PDS system mein jo paisa aa jata hai. Now, PDS system में जो essential commodity आती है, तो government of India will bring the commodities PDS के नाम के ऊपर. लेकिन वो PDS में आने के बाद तुरंत वो insurgent के घर चला जाता है. फिर insurgent उसको black market में market prices के ऊपर और retail prices के ऊपर. So the government of India's PDS items reach into the insurgent hands. Right, within this only, this parallel government में, या फिर how the government is directly or indirectly involved. So the essential items under the PDS, essential item under the PDS reach in the hands of insurgents, which they sell into the market, open market, which they sell into the open market at the higher prices. सो राइस, वीट, केरोसिन, ये सब PDS वाला उनके घर चला जाता है और उसको बेचना है. मतलब आपको रॉ मटेरियल भी हाँ गवर्नमेंट ही दे रही है, ठीक है, और उसी को हायर प्राइजेस में बेच देना है. PDS आर नॉट वर्किंग, बट यू कैन गेट द आइटम्स इन द PDS बाय पेइंग द हायर प्राइजेस. नाउ दिस इज द समथिंग नेक्सस विच डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट एनीवेयर इन द इंडिया, एंड obviously this will not exist without the knowledge of the government, because here both the contract is also allocated and the essential commodity items are also allocated. But this is where they are so strong that they enjoy a lot of dominance there, and if you are not giving in, so obviously they are going to create a difficult situation, law and order situation. Now the third, you can write third, that is getting involved into cross border organized crimes or organized activities, getting involved into cross border organized crimes and earning the money through it. That's implicit when we are saying organized crime. Now here obviously you can write that is a drug trafficking, arms trafficking, cross border drug trafficking, arms trafficking, human trafficking. Even the cattle trafficking is common in northeast areas. Cattle trafficking. Now here, if you see the geography, there is a golden triangle that exists on the east of the northeast. So golden triangle, Thailand, Laos, Myanmar. Okay, so these Laos. So इससे एक golden triangle बनता है. तो वो golden triangle is famous for the poppy cultivation. So certainly because the India is situated, okay, very close to this golden triangle. So the people here act as a courier for the transfer of these drugs from one end to another end. Are you understanding? So those northeast people, they have the lot of domination. Earlier क्या होता था कि ये international drugs का एक syndicate है, उनकी ही अपनी courier service थी. तो इनको खाली पैसे देते थे कि आपकी रीजन से हमारा आदमी चला जाएगा, आप इतने इतने पैसे ले लो, ग्रांट हिम द सेफ पैसेज. सो अर्लियर देर वॉज अ इंटरनेशनल सिंडिकेट, यू नीड टू जस्ट प्रोवाइड देम द सॉर्ट ऑफ अ रेंट और फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मनी. बट नाउ अ डेज दे बिकम सो डोमिनेंट दैट दे डू नॉट अलाउ देम टू गो. सो दे देमसेल्फ हैव बिकम अ कुरियर्स नाउ. अर्लियर दे यूज टू गेट सम फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मनी, नाउ दे देमसेल्फ आर एक्टिंग एज अ कुरियर्स फॉर द ड्रग पैसेज. Okay, so have you understood this point? Okay, same fear, drug trafficking, etc. So these are the three different mechanisms through which they are earning the money and sustaining themselves. Okay, so in fact, these are the three different organized activities which are happening in the Northeast. So one is the extortion, kidnapping, contract killing. Second is the government money which is getting into the hands of insurgent through two different ways. That is, one is through getting the contract, and second is essential commodity items, that is a PDS items. Third is external source, that is through the involvement into the cross-border organized crime activities. Okay, so these are the three. Now come to the Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir. Second, if you see in case of Jammu and Kashmir, there is not as such the internal mechanisms through which they earn the money. It is mostly the external source of funding. Okay, so the most significant source is external source of funding and the organized racket. Now right here, what are the external sources? So primarily the Jammu and Kashmir militancy get through the donation from the Islamic countries. Donation from Islamic countries, and this donation enter into the India through the Pakistan. Okay, through the Pakistan it enter into the India. So external may donation. Second is the money earned through the drug trafficking. Okay, वहाँ पे golden triangle है, इस side golden crescent है. Okay, crescent is this like moon. So this is Afghanistan, Pakistan and Iran. Pak, Afghan, Iran, that is a golden crescent. And here there was a golden triangle, Thailand, Myanmar, Laos. Okay, so this area, and India is situated in between the two. So you can imagine that, because there is also poppy cultivation, this is also poppy cultivation. So here money earned through drug trafficking. So drug trafficking, now earlier here the Indian government ke side mein keval courier bante the, theek hai, yahan se yahan se ye courier hoke yahan pe aur bhi ja raha hai, yahan se courier hoke aur idhar bhi ja raha hai. But now the Punjab has become a consumption area also, so they don't now act as a only courier. Ha, Udta Punjab dekha hoga, theek hai. To yes, most of the time se wo क्या नाम है उनका, आलिया भट्ट, देखा है वो फेंक देती है, वो मतलब फेंकना नहीं है, वो ड्रग्स रहता है माल. ओके, सो दैट्स हाउ दे रिच देयर ऑन द स्पॉट. ओके, गो अहेड. हाँ, आपको पता होगा वीड कौन सा अच्छा रहता है, मतलब आजकल ये भी चलता है. ठीक है, हाँ रे, हाँ ठीक है. मनी अर्न थ्रू द ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग. नाउ यहाँ पे जो है ISI जो अर्न मनी करता है, या फिर जो टेरर लिंक वहाँ पे मनी अर्न करते हैं, तो इसमें दो चीज़ें हैं. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देर इज़ अ पॉपी कल्टिवेशन देर इट सेल्फ. सो दे आर नॉट जस्ट द कुरियर, कुरियर की तो एक ले ही रहे हैं, प्लस दे आर ऑल्सो टैक्सिंग द लोकल पीपल देर. पॉपी कल्टिवेशन के ऊपर भी टैक्स है. सो दे आर अर्निंग द मनी थ्रू टू डिफरेंट वेज. ISI मनी इज अर्निंग, वन इज बाय इम्पोजिंग द टैक्स, लोकल टैक्स ऑन द पॉपी कल्टिवेशन, एंड सेकेंड इज बाय प्रोवाइडिंग द कुरियर. कुरियर ऑब्वियसली थ्रू द लश्कर ए तोयबा, जैश मोहम्मद, दे बिकम. एंड सेकेंड थिंग इज देर इज़ अ फंडिंग ऑल्सो. सो देर इज़ अ वेरी बिग रैकेट हियर. फर्स्ट इज टैक्स उनके ऊपर लग रहा है, वो मनी आपको आ रहा है. फिर सेकेंड इज उस मनी के थ्रू आप टेरर फाइनेंस कर रहे हो, थर्ड इज यू आर ऑल्सो यूजिंग दीज पीपल नॉट ओनली फाइनेंसिंग दैम बट ऑल्सो दे आर एक्टिंग एज अ कुरियर फॉर यस प्रोवाइडिंग दिस ड्रग. सो द होल ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग रैकेट इज देयर. थर्ड इज हवाला ट्रांजेक्शन. हवाला ट्रांजेक्शन, हवाला ट्रांजेक्शन. सो वट इज हवाला? यस एनीबडी नोस? हाँ, इलीगल मीन्स ही है, लेकिन हाउ, वॉट हैपन्स एक्चुअली हवाला में? सब इलीगली है, इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी. मनी इज, पैसे लेके जाते हैं बैग में, रेबन गॉगल एंड दिस ब्रिक फेस. यस, एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट अ फिजिकल ट्रांसफर ऑफ द मनी, इट्स द वैल्यू ऑफ द मनी दैट इज बींग ट्रांसफर्ड. ओके, सम सॉर्ट ऑफ पेपर. सी, यू रिक्वायर अ बैंकिंग फॉर ट्रांजेक्शन ऑफ मनी बिटवीन द टू कंट्री. लाइक यहाँ पे अगर आपका काम कर रहा है, जैसे ड्रग यहाँ पे पहुँच गया, इनको पेमेंट करनी है यहाँ पे. सो पेमेंट करने के लिए आपको कहीं पे बैंक में इनका डिपॉजिट करना पड़ेगा या फिर पैसे इनको देने पड़ेंगे. सो इन इधर केसेस यू हैव टू, लाइक पैसे इतने छोटे नहीं होते, 100-200 रुपये. ओके, बहुत ज़्यादा पैसा रहता है. एंड बैंकिंग यू कैन नॉट अप्लाई. सो हवाला इज अ मेथड विच बाईपासिस द बैंकिंग सिस्टम, फॉर्मल बैंकिंग सिस्टम, एंड इट एक्चुअली वेंट थ्रू द इनफॉर्मल मेथड. देर इज ऑल्सो नो फिजिकल ट्रांसफर ऑफ मनी, बट देर इज अ ट्रांसफर ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ मनी. सो एक टोकन यहाँ पे, जैसे बिटकॉइन समझ लो, बिटकॉइन की तरह आपने मान लिया कि ये बिटकॉइन आपके पास आ गया तो इतने इतने पैसे आ गए. सो सम सॉर्ट ऑफ बॉन्ड पेपर इज बींग ट्रांजेक्टेड. दिस हवाला इट्सेल्फ इज ऑल्सो ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम. ये जो डी कंपनी है दाऊद की, ओके, सो दे कंट्रोल द होल हवाला सिस्टम. ओके, इन द साउथ एशिया, साउथ ईस्ट एशिया एंड वेस्ट एशिया, फ्रॉम दिस स्ट्रेट ऑफ, यस, वहाँ पे, हाँ, दुबई से लेके यहाँ पे स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलक्का तक. ओके, स्ट्रेट ऑफ बाबे मानदेब, ओके, या गल्फ स्ट्रीट से लेके, सो पूरा का हवाला ट्रांजैक्शन का सिस्टम है. सो दिस इज वेयर वी सी दैट हवाला ट्रांजैक्शन इज ऑल्सो ऑर्गेनाइज एक्टिविटी विच हैपन्स एट द क्रॉस बॉर्डर्स. सो दीज पीपल विल ऑल्सो हेल्प एंड दिस इज हाउ द फंडिंग इज जनरेटेड. एंड द फोर्थ वन इज फेक करेंसी. ओके, दैट इज पेडलिंग ऑफ फेक करेंसी. Fake currency, peddling of fake currency, that is again happen across. Fake currency में दो issues है again. One is funding also, but second is to destabilize the Indian economy also. Okay, so once you pump up this money, then the liquidity in the market get increased. If the liquidity will increase, it will challenge for the monetary policy, inflation, so rest of the things also. So this is how there is a racket in the Kashmir. So in Kashmir, there is no as such the parallel government. There is no as such extortion and the direct. Although there will be, but very less significant. More, it's about the external sources. So let me repeat: a donation coming from Islamic countries. यहाँ पे बहुत सारे trust है. Okay, trust has been created so as to take money at one particular place and then fund. Money through the drug trafficking, hawala transaction and fake currency. Okay, so these are the rackets. Now, right, the third one, that is with respect to the hinterland terrorism or linkages we have established in case of Mumbai blast, likho, directly likho. Okay, in fact, this is a very significant for us to understand. That is Mumbai blast or Bombay blast. 1992 or 3? Okay, 3 demolition. Now, why Bombay blast is we are concerned? There are many terrorist activities and terrorist organizations which are getting involved. But why we are taking this as a special case? Because we have seen in case of terrorism in the first class, this is Lashkar-e-Toyba ka humne dekha 26/11 Mumbai terror attack. Ye jo tha 2008 ka. Then we have also seen Pathankot attack, Uri attack, Parliament attack, etc., etc. We haven't mentioned the Bombay blast there. Okay, because the Bombay blast was very typical and very different. It was not by the Lashkar-e-Toyba, Jaish-e-Mohammed or Hizbul Mujahideen, etc., etc. It was involvement of the D company. Okay, that is Daoud. Now, if you see the D company is actually involved in the organized crime, and organized crime's interest is financial interest. So how come the financial interest company got involved into the terrorism? So this is what we are trying to establish, that this was a unique of its kind where the organized crime getting involved into the terror attack. Yes. Now, reason being is when this was significant for two reasons. One is when there was a Babri Masjid demolition has happened a year back. So at that particular point of time, the Islamic country obviously wanted to take the revenge on the Babri Masjid demolition, and there has to be certain sort of attack that has to be prepared. Now, this Lashkar-e-Toyba, Jaish-e-Mohammed, it was not that easy for them to cause unprecedented damage immediately as a part of a revenge. Now, Daud is somebody who is running the underground racket in Mumbai, okay, for organized crime. And Daud is also a supplier of arms and ammunition for the Pakistan and different Islamic countries. So he is supplying the arms and ammunitions and earning the funding. So there was a client and there was a supplier and the buyer relationship. So they were the client and he was the supplier. So money. So इन्होंने क्या किया कि हम आपका जो है financial ये जो है आपका बंद कर देंगे. Okay. Since we are in a good terms and we also buy, so you have to do us a favor. Okay. And you have to do us a favor by getting involved into the bomb blast. Now, this is more of a compulsion. He is not somebody who is, we are not saying that he is not terrorist, wagera, as a niye, but principally he is more for the economic purpose. So economic purpose, because of compulsion of economic purpose, because you have to establish the relationship with them, because your whole interest, financial interest is involved with the having a good relationship with them. So he has to do something for them. So this is where we are seeing the blurring of the lines between the organized crime and the terrorism, where the organized criminal is getting into the terrorist fold. So here, Bombay blast, you can see that this blast, which was there in 1993. So the D company was involved in carrying out the attack. D company was involved in carrying out the terror attack. Now the D company is essentially a organized group. Okay, D company is essentially an organized group. But here getting involved into the terror attack. So this is the first attack, which was a terrorist attack, not by the non-state actors, but by the purely an organized company. So write something about D company. D company headed by obviously Daud, and it has presence in almost, yes, kitne countries mein, kitne uski sarkar dhoond rahi hai, 12 mulkon ki, haan. So 12 countries, presence in, haan, 11 the, theek hai, likhe, 11, 12, Amitabh mein 11 the, abhi 12 ho gaye. Yes, so presence in the 12 countries, okay, that from the Strait of Hormuz to the Strait of Malacca, you can write, it has organized criminal activity extending from Strait of Hormuz. Kahan pe hai Strait of Hormuz? Persian Gulf, okay. Strait of Hormuz to the Strait of Malacca. To pura inhone West Asia, South Asia and Southeast Asia. Strait of Hormuz, geography mein nahi hua hai ka? Hormuz. Strait of Malacca. Malacca Strait is in between. Yes, Indonesia and Malaysia. These are the choke points also. Okay, these are famous choke points. So this extension, that is if you see the West Asia completely, then South Asia and the Southeast Asia. So it has a presence. And they are involved into, right, the next, that is, kya kya likha hai, headed by Daud Ibrahim. And yes, they have presence in the 12 countries. They are involved in drug trafficking, arms trafficking, hawala transaction, drug trafficking, arms trafficking, hawala transaction, gold smuggling, diamond smuggling. Abu Salim aur unke sath ek heroine bhi gaye the, dekho, diamond, kya naam, kaun se? Monica Bedi, Monica Bedi, haan. मनी माइंडेड, डायमंड माइंडेड, ठीक है ठीक है. यस सो क्या क्या लिखा है? ड्रग ट्राफिकिंग, आर्म्स ट्राफिकिंग, हवाला, गोल्ड स्मगलिंग, डायमंड स्मगलिंग, अगेन किडनैपिंग, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट किलिंग, एक्सटॉर्शन, किडनैपिंग, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट किलिंग, एक्सटॉर्शन, देन पायरेसी ऑफ दिस सीडी वगैरह आती है देखो मार्केट में, ओके, ये सब पायरेसीज, पायरेसी ऑफ डिफरेंट गुड्स, इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द मूवीज ऑल्सो प्रोडक्शन में आ जाता है, साजिद नादिया वाला ये वो ऐसे वैसे, सलमान खान को भी बुलाते हैं नचाने के लिए, ऐसे बोला जाता है, पता नहीं क्या क्या रहता है. संजय दत्त, हाँ संजय दत्त ऑब्वियसली. तो यस 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 सर्टनली. सो दीज आर द दे हैव द लिंकेजेस बिकॉज दे वॉन्ट टू समवेयर इन्वेस्ट द मनी. इनफैक्ट दिस इज द न्यू ट्रेंड वेयर पहले जो था इलेजिटिमेट एक्टिविटीज थे, अब जो है लेजिटिमेट एक्टिविटीज में वो फंडिंग कर रहे हैं ताकि दे विल नॉट कम अंडर द स्कैनर. ये सब आप इलेजिटिमेट देखोगे, बॉलीवुड देखोगे तो आप वो फंडिंग अब नहीं दिखाई देती है क्योंकि वो वाइट कलर हो जा रहा है उसका. IPL स्पॉट फिक्सिंग, IPL में पूरा जो मनी है दैट्स ऑल्सो कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम. देन बॉलीवुड है, देन पायरेसी है. सो दीज आर द एरियाज वेयर नाउ दे आर मेकिंग इट मोर डिफिकल्ट. ठीक है, यस दैट इज इट. सो दिस इज अबाउट द इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइज कंपनी, अ क्लासिकल केस जिसको बोला जाता है, बट हियर इट इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग इन्वॉल्व इन टू द टेररिज्म ऑल्सो दैट वी आर सीइंग बॉम्बे ब्लास्ट. सो वॉट वी हैव रिटन इज एक्चुअली ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम एंड 1993 ब्लास्ट इज अ एक्ट ऑफ अ टेरर. ओके नाउ देर आर अदर कंपनीज ऑल्सो लाइक देर इज अ अरुण गौली गैंग. ओके राइट, देर आर अदर छोटा मोटा जो नाम्स और वो है अरुण गौली. लोग छोटे दिखते हैं लेकिन काम इनके बहुत खतरनाक बड़े बड़े रहते हैं. अरुण गौली, JAWLI JAVLI जो भी लिखना है लिखिए. इन सिलेबस ऑब्वियसली. देन छोटा राजन बड़ा राजन जो भी है, हाँ छोटा शकील लिखिए, छोटा शकील, छोटा राजन, छोटा शकील, छोटा भीम, ओके ऐसे भी है क्या, लिखिए लिखिए. ओके सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द कंपनीज. अबू सलेम क्या नाम है उनका, यस. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द पीपल हु आर डायरेक्टली द पार्ट ऑफ, हाँ तो वही ना, नाम लिखना है आपको डी कंपनी के सम ऑफ द क्रिमिनल्स. लतीफ क्या नाम था इनका, रईस लतीफ, राशिद लतीफ, ये जो रईस मूवी जो बनी है. यस ही वॉज इनफैक्ट सो स्ट्रांग दैट वंस द दाऊद केम इन टू द गुजरात, ओके फॉर द सम ऑफ द लोकल कंसाइनमेंट, तो ही हैज सो मच ऑफ लोकल प्रेजेंस देयर. इनफैक्ट the Daud got impressed, he could not able to take his consignment because this ye jo rais wala hai shahrukh khan jis din ka role, kya naam hai inka, abdul latif hai shayad, abdul latif. So he was very strong there and then Daud went back and then said that ye kon aadmi hai mujhe chahiye, agar aapne movie dekha hai to usme ek dikhaya dekho jo head rehta hai. So that is actually a Daud and this was abdul latif. So abdul latif got, but abdul latif has a very अनादर एंगल टू हिम, जो गरीबों से लेता है टाइप वाला, कौन सा ये रॉबिनहुड स्टाइल था वो. सो रॉबिनहुड स्टाइल में ही यूज टू लाइक, उनका जो रैकेट था वो लिकर, इलीगल लिकर रैकेट है. सी द थिंग इज वी हैव डिस्कस सम ऑफ द वेरी रीसेंट ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, बट दीज आर ऑल्सो ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम, इलीगल इलिसिट लिकर माफियाज, देन प्रोस्टिट्यूशन माफियाज, then child pornography and these related mafias. So these are also like selling of the organs, different organs. So that's also a racket which are the part of organized crime. So this was actually the supplier of the liquor who went on to become one of the very famous organized criminal there, to an extent that he has challenged the this Daud also, and the Daud befriended with him later on, and then it is being, he has also been charged, treated and responsible for the Bombay terror attack, one of the person there. But that's what, when in the movie it has been shown, when he get to know that this there's some religion activities were involved into the violence and the crime, then he realizes that a particular humanistic side. Because if you see in that particular area, when the Gujarat police is coming to capture him, everybody is saying that he is a messiah and the god for us. So actually he was taking the money, not all money was investing, but certainly he was doing some sort of a charity. So that sort of a Robin Hood style, that you are doing something good for the society, but still you will be termed as a criminal because the means through which you are earning the money is absolutely immoral one. Okay, so that's a part of the Rais story, or this, all the gangs, invariably these gangs, local gangs are involved in. There is a reason why they do the this humanistic activities, because they require a local protection also. Okay, so that's also one of the reason why in their local areas where they are best, so they are going to involve into the some sort of charity and the, this humanitarian activities. Yes, so that's about it in case of now. Right, the next, that is a money laundering hum karenge. Okay, money laundering. Isme jo how to tackle the organized crimes and all these aspects. देखिए ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम्स एंड ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग ऐसे भी आ सकता है, तो आपको मतलब ये हमने अलग तरीके से स्टडी किया, आपको अब आराम से लिखना आना चाहिए, बिकॉज यू हैव टू डेवलप दैट लिंकेजेस बिटवीन द गोल्डन ट्रायंगल एंड द गोल्डन क्रिसेंट. सो जस्ट हेडलाइन भी लिख सकते हो टेररिज्म एंड इट्स लिंकेजेस विद द ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग, ड्रग्स स्मगलिंग और ड्रग ट्रैफिकिंग, जिसको कई बार नार्को टेररिज्म भी बोला जाता है. नार्को टेररिज्म इज अ डिपेंडेंस ऑन ईच अदर. सो नार्को टेररिज्म में आपको दोनों डिस्क्राइब करने हैं, ईस्ट में गोल्डन ट्रायंगल और वेस्ट में गोल्डन क्रिसेंट, एंड देयर हाउ दे आर सप्लाइंग ईच अदर. टेररिज्म कैसा है, नार्को क्या है, नार्को इज अ ड्रग्स रिलेटेड, सो शो इट गोल्डन ट्रायंगल एंड गोल्डन क्रिसेंट. एंड टेररिज्म क्या है, दिस गोल्डन क्रिसेंट का मनी जो है टेरर फाइनेंसिंग में जा रहा है ऑन द वेस्टर्न साइड इन केस ऑफ कश्मीर, whereas in case of eastern side golden triangle ka money jo ja raha hai in order to sustain the northeast insurgency. So this is called as narco terrorism, where the drug funding is being used for the terror, financing the terrorism in India. That is called as the narco terrorism. Narco terrorism ke under aap pakde gaye to maximum crime 10 saal ki usme rigorous imprisonment hai, otherwise PMLA के एक्ट के अंदर, दैट इज प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एक्ट के ऊपर, मैक्सिमम पनिशमेंट 7 years ऑफ रिगरस इम्प्रिजनमेंट है, लेकिन नार्को टेररिज्म में इट इज 10 years. सो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, बिकॉज इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस वी ऑल्सो सी दैट दिस ड्रग पेडलिंग हैपन्स. सो ड्रग पेडलिंग के केसेस में अगर पकड़े जाओगे तो फिर द एक्ट्स आर वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. ओके, दे आर नॉन बेलेबल एक्ट्स एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गेट आउट ऑफ दिस the whole racket. Okay, yes, so that's another component you should remember about between the drugs terrorism and the organized crime. So this three points you should remember: what are the similarities between organized crime and terrorism, then what are the differences in between the organized crime and terrorism, and the last is the linkages between organized crime. See, the thing is, in contemporary time there is a blurring of line between the organized crime and the terrorism. The Daud is being now the terrorist also, and the terrorist, in order to sustain themselves financially, they themselves are getting involved into the organized crime. So there is a now ek middle point aata hai jahan se ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम और यहाँ पे टेररिज्म है, तो ये यहाँ 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 आते हैं, क्योंकि ये टेररिज्म पॉलिटिकल भी कर रहे हैं और यहाँ पे ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम भी कर रहे हैं इन ऑर्डर टू अर्न द फंडिंग, एंड इनका पॉलिटिकल में उनका जो फेस फ्रंट पे बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट भी रहेगा, इनका जो है मनी फ्रंट पे है लेकिन इनको भी बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट करना पड़ेगा. सो देर इज अ मिडल पॉइंट बिटवीन द टू. दिस इज नोन एज अ ब्लैक होल सिंड्रोम. ओके, ब्लैक होल सिंड्रोम में द ब्लरिंग ऑफ द लाइन्स बिटवीन द ऑर्गेनाइज क्राइम एंड द टेररिज्म. सो बोथ ऑफ देम आर डिस्प्लेइंग ईच अदर्स कैरेक्टर्स. सो ब्लैक होल है, आपको समझ में नहीं आएगा कि दिस इज अ ऑर्गेनाइज ग्रुप और दिस इज अ टेरर ग्रुप. So if somebody, now since our understanding is clear, but if you see the Daud and 1992, in fact he got the headlines only after the Bombay terror attack. So people will easily term him as a terrorism. So this is something where he has reached into the black hole syndrome. So the same way Northeast people and lot many other people are involved into the terror activities. So this is something what is called as the black hole syndrome, where there is a blurring of line between the two different things. Now, what are the steps that has to be taken? You just write, there is particularly one convention, okay? The India is a signatory to this convention, that is United Nations Convention on Transnational Organized Crime. India is a signatory to United Nations Convention on Transnational Organized Crime. This is important because there are international linkages in there are international syndicates, and you need an international cooperation. Apart from that, there are other laws. We are going to do all of them together because organized crime, money laundering, and black money, these three things are all interdependent. See, the thing is, now in the next class we are going to do, ये ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम से पैसा आपने जनरेट किया, उस पैसे की कोई वैल्यू नहीं है अगर वो आप मार्केट में नहीं ला सकते लेजिटिमेट सोर्सेस के थ्रू. अदरवाइज इट इज जस्ट अ पीस ऑफ पेपर दैट यू नीड टू बर्न देम. अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू ब्रिंग देम इनटू द फाइनेंशियल मार्केट, अ फॉर्मल फाइनेंशियल मार्केट, देर इज नो यूज ऑफ मनी, इट्स अ सिंपल पीस ऑफ पेपर. सो द प्रोसेस थ्रू विच यू आर हाइडिंग एंड कंसीलिंग यूर सोर्स and making it appear as a legitimate source, that process is called money laundering. That is converting the black money from the white money. Apart from that, so this process is going to be a very important that we are going to discuss in the next class. Second is black money. Black money is not just about the organized crime. There are a hell lot of other things. Okay, there are legitimate ways also which are black money, because something which is unaccounted and unreported and untaxed. So non-taxed money is a black money which can be earned through the otherwise legitimate source, but you are not reporting it, not paying the tax. And second is obviously earning through the illegitimate ways. So we are going to see in the next class what is a black money. We are going to then see what is a money laundering, how the black money is converted into white money, and how these three, four things, that is organized crime, terror financing, black money, and the money laundering is interrelated, and what are the steps to move forward. In the tomorrow's class we'll do. And is today's class number konsa tha? Fourth. Okay. So what is remaining is this two, three topics, and cyber crime, and then border management. Okay, two, three classes. Yes. Thank you so much. अरे असाइनमेंट आज का लिखिए. यस यू कैन राइट दिस, दैट इज अ डिस्कस द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम एंड इट्स लिंकेजेस विद टेररिज्म इन इंडिया. ओके, डिस्कस डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम एंड इट्स लिंकेजेस विद टेररिज्म इन इंडिया.